Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Well, next Monday is Chinese New Year Day.
下个星期马上就是农历年了。And
as a Chinese, every year, Chinese New Year is always a special time.
身为华人,大年初一都是最特别的日子。The
Chinese race is the largest ethnic group with 1/5 of the world's population.
华人是世界上最多人口的种族,占了1/5。There
are more people that speak Chinese than any other language in the world.
在世界上说华语的人口超过其他所有的语言。It
is also the most commonly used language already on the internet today.
也是今天网络上面最常使用的一种语言了。
Together with the Jews, Chinese is one of the earliest and the oldest enduring civilizations.
跟犹太人一样, 华人也是历史最为悠久的一个文化。
It has a 4,500 years of unbroken history.
整个历史洪流当中将近经历了4,500年。
But I wonder how many of you have experience this when we become Christians.
我不晓得有多少人呢,当你做基督徒时候经过这种情况。
You see, to most of us Chinese, when we become Christians, somehow we are made to feel like we have forsaken our Chinese roots.
我们中国人做了基督徒之后,好像让我们感觉到我们放弃自己华人的根了。That
we have abandoned our Chinese heritage and culture.
放弃自己的文化,我们遗产传来的产业。That
we have embraced a foreign Western religion, a religion of the white people.
现在去拥抱是西方外来的文化,是西方白种人的宗教。And
so we kind of feel a little embarrassed.
我们感觉好像有点不好意思了。
Especially during Chinese New Year season.
特别在过农历年的时候。You
meet your family and relatives and say, oh, we hear that now you're a Christian.
听到你的朋友、亲戚、家人说：“哎呦，听说你现在做基督徒了。”
You no longer love your family.
哦，不爱你家人了哈。Huh?
You no longer love your parents anymore, huh?
你再不再爱你爸爸妈妈了。
Oh, they will say, well, you know, now you 假刚当, is it?
You eat potato. 哇，现在假刚当，哇，已经不一样了。
Because if you're a Chinese, you should either be a Taoist, a Confucianist, or a Buddhist.
因为如果你是华人，你要就是道教徒，要不然佛教徒，要不然儒教徒了。Now
I want to say this: that those are great religions.
我要告诉你,那些都是很好的宗教。
The many, many millions of believers and followers of Buddhism, Taoism, and Confucianism.
在今天世界上,有上百万追随着道教、儒教、佛教的信徒。
But today I want to give you a little bit of education.
可是今天呢,要给大家一些教育。
Turn to your neighbor and say you're going to enjoy the word.
跟爸爸就享受神的话语。
The Chinese history has a 4,500 year unbroken record.
整个中华的历史将近有4,500年不断延续下来。Let's
take this to be 0 BC.
把这个当作公元初年。So
now we are here, we're at 2009.
现在我们在2009年这里。Year
of the ox.
牛年。
If this is a youth service, I'll say, turn to your neighbor and moo. All right, anyway.
不可以跟旁边的moo啊。
Moo, okay. But you know what? The Chinese history stretches until 2500 BC.
华人的历史可以一直往前推到主前2500多年。
Now, Taoism came about 6 BC.
道教大概是公元前六世纪来的。About
the 5th BC, you have Confucianism, and you have, I spelled wrongly, Buddhism.
而大概在公元第五世纪的时候,有儒家跟佛教出现。So
the big question is, what about those 2,000 years?
问题就在这中间2000多年呢?
Before Taoism, Confucianism, and Buddhism, what did the Chinese people believe in?
在道教、儒家、佛教出现之前，华人相信的是什么？
What is interesting is this: we have very clear historical records.
很有意思的，我们有非常清楚的历史记录在。
For the first 2,000 years of their history, the Chinese people worship a singular supreme god, and not many dozens or millions of deities.
在这2000多年当中,华人一直在敬拜的是一位独一的最高主权的真神,而不是许许多多的神明。They
worship a god by the name of 上帝.
他们敬拜的这位叫上帝的神。Today
I'm going to write in my broken Chinese.
今天我要来练习我的中文字。
All right. Now, and this When you read the historical records,
当你读到整个历史记录里头,
上帝 has exactly the same character, nature, and power as the God of the Old Testament.
实际上这位上帝跟我们旧约相信的神有同样的品格、同样的性情、同样的能力。
But while the Hebrew people called him Yahweh or Jehovah,
虽然犹太人把他称为耶和华或亚伯,
the Chinese people from the beginning called him 上帝, the King that lives above the Most High God.
华人却把这位神称之为上帝，是一位君王，在万物之上居在天上的。
Some of them call him as 天 or as 上天。
也有人把他直接称之为天了。
Now you notice how you write the word 天?
你注意天怎么写?
Everything that is big, that is da, he's bigger than them. He's the Most High.
在天下至大至上最高的那个就是至高神。
So the Old Testament calls him the Most High God.
所以旧约里面称他为至高神。
Let's give the Most High God a big clap. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
China's greatest historian was a man by the name of Sima Qian.
在中国当中有一个非常了不起的史学家叫司马迁。
In his classic historical records, he recorded of a king called 皇帝 or the Yellow Emperor.
而在他流传千古的著作史记当中记载了第一个人叫皇帝。
Now, 皇帝 is supposed to be the originator of all Han people, Han Chinese.
皇帝基本上是所有汉族人的始祖。
He lived around 2400 BC to 2500 BC, that means right from the beginning.
他所居住的时代，但是公元前2400到2500年， 在最开头的时候。
And Sima Qian recorded that 皇帝 actually built an altar in Taishan, which is the mountain in Shantung province, to worship 上帝 God, the one supreme God.
司马迁记载， 皇帝特别到了中国山东的泰山， 在那里为上帝这位神筑了一座坛崇拜他。
Sima Qian also recorded in his historical records a comment by a Han Dynasty scholar.
而司马迁在史记当中同时也记载汉代另外一位史学家的记录。
Well, the Chinese, I'm going to ask Lu to read what was written.
这位史学家郑玄他写的中文是说, 上帝者天之别名也,神无二主。
In other words, 上帝 is another name for 天。
上帝就是天的另外一个名字。
And he says, he says this, the spirits do not have two lords. In other words, the Lord your God is one.
他讲得很清楚,只有独一真神,没有两个主。
Again, it confirms exactly what the Old Testament says.
再一次又印证我们旧约所教导的。
Now, there is also a song found in the collected statues of the Ming Dynasty.
另外在大明会典当中有一首收集到的当时的歌谣。
I am not even going to attempt to try to read the 文言文。
哇, 读这个文言文大概会昏倒的。
But Lulu is able to do it, so let's
Lulu可以为大家念出来。 这边这个歌谣他说, 余习洪荒之初兮,魂蒙, 五行未雨兮,两曜未明, 其中挺立兮,有无容身, 神皇初雨兮,始判浊清, 理天理地人兮,群物生生。
Now let me translate it for you.
这个要为大家解释一下了。
Of the old in the beginning, there was a great chaos without form and dark.
在创造之初,一切是混沌灰暗的。
The five planets have not begun to revolve, nor the two lights to shine.
五颗星星尚未运转,那两个光体也未照亮。
In the midst of it, there existed neither form nor sound.
在这当中,既无声响,也无形体。You,
O spiritual sovereign, came forth in your sovereignty and first did separate the impure from the pure.
而主权之神啊,唯有你出来判断所有清浊之分。
Now notice the order. You make heaven, you make earth, you make man. All things became alive with reproducing power.
注意它的顺序哦,你立了天,立了地,创造人,使这一切万物生生不息。
Turn your Bible with me to Genesis chapter 1 and verse 1.
跟我一起翻开创世纪第一章第一节。
Doesn't this commentary sound exactly like the book of Genesis?
诶,这里是不是就像为创世纪写了注释一样?
It says in verse 1, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth.
第一节说,起初神创造天地。
The earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep.
地是空虚混沌,渊面黑暗。
And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters.
神的灵运行在水面上。
And then it says God separated light from darkness, and the land from the waters.
最后神将光与暗分开，水与地分开。
And he created trees and plants.
他创造了树木、采书。
Fish and birds and beasts of the field, and then he created man.
有鱼、有鸟、田间的野兽，之后他创造人。
And Genesis 1 says, all were given reproducing power to produce after their own kind.
而创世纪告诉我们，每一个都有生育的能力，照他们各从其类的生产。
Can you see, long before all this worship came in,
你看到早在这些拜偶像的事情之前,
long before Taoism, Confucianism, and Buddhism,
早在这些道教、儒教、佛教之前,
before there were temples that were full of idols for you to worship,
在那些有很多庙宇、那些偶像拜敬之前,
for 2,000 over years, the Chinese people worship a singular supreme sovereign God who is the creator of heaven and earth, and his name is 上帝.
中国人在2000多年一直在敬拜是一位独一有至高主权的神，他的名叫上帝。
Who has the same nature, character, and power of Jehovah Yahweh God of the Old Testament.
而他的本性、品格与能力跟我们旧约的亚伯上帝是一样的。
Now, nobody knows when Chinese writing was originated.
没有人知道中文的文字起源在哪里。
But most will agree, Chinese writing came about probably in 2500 BC.
可是大部分人都同意，大概公元前2500年就有了中国的文字了。
So centuries before the Egyptians built the pyramids, you have the Chinese writing.
所以在埃及人还没盖金字塔好几个世纪之前，中国人就开始写字了。
And with Chinese writing, with the ability to write, that means you can document history.
在中国人能够有文字写下来，代表你可以记载历史了。
Now, this is very interesting.
这就很有意思啦。
Because from the time they were able to document history, there were several global events that everybody could remember.
在他们能够有能力记载历史的时候，有一些全球性的事件是大家通通记得的。
During the same time as 2500 BC,
就大概在公元前2500年那样的时代里,
you have the flood.
在这之前有洪水。
You have the Tower of Babel.
在那时候有巴别塔。
Now, what other events were there the people possibly, if they were alive, and if those events were true, they could remember?
而在那个时代还活着的人，还有什么样的事情是人家永远不会忘记的呢？
Now, I mean, wouldn't you agree, if there's a flood that covers the whole earth, then you definitely will remember.
如果一个全世界的大洪水，你大概一定都会记得吧。
If there is a Tower of Babel that caused people to be scattered everywhere and languages to come forth, surely you remember.
如果巴别塔使得人们四散到各处，语言变乱了，你一定会记得啊。Now,
if those events were true,
如果这些事件是真实的,
and that the Bible is not a fable,
圣经不是随便的神话故事,
then the people that are alive around 2500 BC, they must remember the creation story.
那在公元2500年的人，他们也不会忘记创造的故事。
Because Adam was alive 1,600 years before.
因为在1,600年前，亚当还活在世上呢。
You see, when the flood came, you know, Methuselah just died.
你要了解，是在马土撒拉刚死的时候，洪水降临。
And when Methuselah was alive, Adam was also alive.
当马土撒拉在世的时候，亚当也还活在世上哦。
In those days, the people lived a long time.
那个年代的人活得很长寿的。Adam
lived 900 years.
亚当活了900多年。
Methuselah 969 years.
马土撒拉活了969年。In
fact, it was only 8 generations from creation to the flood.
实际上从创造到洪水才8个世代而已。So
if these things were true,
如果这些都是真实的,
then people alive must surely remember them.
当时存活的人也一定记得他才对啊。And
surely they want to document down in their historical records. Now, Chinese writings are unique because somehow they have this ability to capture Chinese history. Because they don't use letters, they use characters in picture form.
因为华文不是用字母拼组在一起，而是用形态写出来的。
So every Chinese word not only expresses a meaning, it captures a history.
因此每一个华文字不但是表达语意思，还能够带出历史来。
Every character tells a story.
每一个文字可以讲一篇故事。
So if all these things had happened,
如果这一切都曾经发生过,
And that the Chinese people were the descendants of the Tower of Babel.
而华人也是在巴比塔之后散出来的百姓。
They were the descendants of Noah.
他们是挪亚的后裔的话。
Surely they want to record all these global cataclysmic events.
当然他们要记载一下这种全球灾难性的事件在。
And for the next 20 minutes or so, I'm going to show you that all these global events were documented in Chinese history.
接下来20分钟，我让你看见所有全球事件都记载在华文历史里面。
Come on, let's give the Lord a big hand.
为主热烈的拍掌。
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All right, go with me to Genesis 1 and verse 26. Let's start there.
创世纪章16节这里开始。
It says, Genesis 1:26.
创世纪章16节。
Then God said, "Let us make man in our image."
神说，让我们照我们的形象造人。The
word make also means to create.
这个造就是创造的造。Create
in Chinese is the word 造。
中文的造就是这个创造的造字。Now,
notice how you write this word.
注意到这个字怎么写啊?
All right. This word is written this way.
这个字的写法是这样子。There
was speaking words.
首先有说话的告。As
words was spoken, movement happens.
当这宣告说出，就有行动产生了。So,
走字旁 over words.
所以在这个告旁边是一个走字边。And
isn't it true, when God spoke the word, living thing began to move?
不是这样吗? 神一说话就开始活物出来了。So
right from the word create, you know that the creation story was recorded there.
从第一个创造的造字，你就看见创造的故事在里面。And
look at verse 22.
你看22节这里。And
God blessed them, and saying, be fruitful and multiply.
神就赐福给他们，让他们生养众多。Now,
we all Chinese, we love this word bless.
所有华人都很爱这个字福。
Chinese New Year, we see this everywhere.
农历年到处都看到这个字。You
know, and sometimes we have this word pasted on our doors and our businesses because this word means good fortune.
不管是家门口、公司门口都贴这个字，为什么？福气就是好运呐。
Yeah, and we want good fortune to come to our families and come to our workplace.
希望福气好运能够到我们的家里面、到公司里来。
Sometimes we write it, we turn it upside down.
有的时候故意倒着贴这个字。That
means the blessings to flow.
代表这个福到了。But
what is prosperity in its original meaning to the Chinese?
可是对华人来说，福原本的意思是什么？How
do you write 福?
福这个字怎么写的？
Now watch, it is 神字旁, it is God.
你看到旁边这个士字旁是神的意思。
Together at one with a mouth.
有一口代表一个人的单位。
So God together with a soul, one mouth.
代表神跟一个人,一个灵魂在一起。
In a garden.
在田园里。
So that is prosperity.
这叫福分啊。
Prosperity to ancient Chinese is not just material wealth and money.
对古代华人来说,福分不光是金钱物质而已。
But it's for God and man to have a one relationship in a fruitful garden, in your fruitful family, or in your workplace.
Hallelujah.
Oh, come on, you want to clap? Give the Lord a big clap. Turn to your neighbor and say, God wants to have a good relationship with you. He wants to prosper you. Amen. Now, look at Genesis 2 and verse 15. It says in verse 15, then the Lord took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to tend and to keep it.
15节，耶和华神将那人安置在伊甸园，使他修理看守。Now,
how do you write the word garden in Chinese?
中文园这个字怎么写呢?
Look at the screen, is this word 园? Everybody say 园.
园.
Now notice, watch everybody.
每一个人仔细看啊。
God took clay to...
神拿了尘土起来。
He breathed with his mouth
用口吹气进去,
on two people. One is a man,
right? 两个人身上,一个是一个人啊,男人,
out of his sight came forth a woman
从他身旁出来了女人,
and put them in a garden.
把他们放在这个范围里,
that's how you got a word garden.
这就是园啦。
Derek is getting excited although he's not Chinese.
Derek不是中国人都开始兴奋了。
Genesis 2 verse 16,
在二章十六节这里,
And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, Of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but the tree of knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat, for in the day that you eat of it, you shall surely die.
耶和华神吩咐他说，园中各样树上的果子你可以随意吃，只是分别善恶树上的果子你不可吃，因为你吃的日子必定死。
So God stopped them.
神拦阻他们,
prohibited them.
禁止他们.
Now, to forbid in Chinese is this word, 禁.
在中文里面讲禁止的禁字.
Now, how do you write the word 禁? Now, look. God put them in a garden. You have trees.
神给他们放在园子里面有这个树林在.
He gave them a revelation, 启示.
还把启示告诉他们这个柿子.
God gave them revelation about the tree.
神给他们这树木的启示.
Don't you eat it.
要吃哦.
If you eat it, you will die.
你吃的话必定死.
Why were there two trees?
为什么放两棵树呢?
Because there was a tree of life and a tree of knowledge of good and evil.
因为有生命之树, 还有分别善恶之树.
All right. Now, well, Genesis chapter 3, verse 1 now.
现在到第三章第一节这里了.
Here came the problem.
这里有问题了.
Now the serpent was more cunning than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made.
耶和华神所造的唯有蛇比田野一切的活物更狡猾。
So the devil came to tempt the woman.
魔鬼来试探女人了。
Now, what is the word tempter in Chinese? The person who gives temptation.
中文试探诱惑人让人入魔的那个魔字怎么写?
Is this word? Look.
你看呢?
Everybody said 魔.
魔.
Now, how do you write the word 魔?
魔这个字怎么写呢?
All right. There was a garden.
这边有个园子。
And then there was a movement.
哇, 有一个行动一撇在那儿。
One guy came to man.
他来找人了, 那个儿子。
Secretly.
私下的。
This is the word.
私
means secret.
这个私就是秘密的意思。
So this word, 鬼, means devil.
这个就是魔鬼那个鬼字了。
Also, it means suspicious. 鬼鬼祟祟。
中文也讲鬼鬼祟祟的。
He came in.
他进来。
Slow movement.
慢动作.
Where did he come?
他到哪儿去?
He came to the among the trees.
他是在树林当中来的.
Undercover.
在灵影之下.
He came as a tempter.
他来引诱人了.
So, he tried to seduce Eve.
他来诱惑夏娃.
Eve, eat the fruit.
夏娃吃着果子.
Eve, the Bible says, lusted after the fruit, got greedy for it.
圣经说夏娃就贪婪看着这果子。
How do you write the word to lust or to 贪婪 the 婪?
这个贪婪的婪字怎么写的呢?
Notice, it's again those three over a woman.
注意到这两棵树在这个女人之上哦。
Because the woman fell into sin first.
因为第一次出现贪婪就是女人掉入罪中。
All right, now temptation is always tough.
试探都是很难搞的.
So what is the Chinese word for difficulty or worry, your stress?
因此当中文讲到困难困惑的时候，这个困字怎么写？
Isn't it this word mu over a boundary?
是不是把个mu圈在这个框框里头呢？
You don't touch this tree.
不要碰这棵树啊。
Oh, very difficult, 很辛苦啊。
很困难啊。
我要。 Well, Eve fell into sin, and then Adam too.
夏娃, 亚当, 他们掉到罪里面了。
And the result of the temptation was sin or 罪.
试探带下的结果就是这个罪字。
Now, the ancient form of 罪, I'm going to write for you, the ancient form.
你要了解罪的古字不是长这样。
All right, I'm now an expert in ancient Chinese.
我现在是古文的专家了。
Okay.
看起来很古的样子哈。
Now, this one, sin, this 罪, the ancient form.
这是中国古文的罪字.
It's actually a man, 人, with his nose.
It's the nose of a man. 是自我的字, 是人的鼻子.
And he feels very bitter, very 辛苦.
而下面是一个辛苦的心字.
So this was the original meaning of the word 罪.
这是罪原来的样子哦.
But when Qin Shi Huang came along, he united China in 221 BC.
可是大概在2100多年时候，秦始皇出现，整合整个中国。
This is the man that built the Great Wall of China.
就这个人建了中国的长城。
And he changed this word From this word, he changed it to this, for against. See, this is the word for, and this is the word against.
所以你看见上面是个四, 下头是一个非。
Now, 秦始皇 was not a Christian.
秦始皇不是基督徒哦。
But by the way, not every emperor was a non-believer. There were many emperors who were believers of God.
可是要先澄清啊, 不是每一个皇帝都是不信主的, 好些皇帝是认识耶稣的。
I'm gonna talk about it more.
这个呢, 我会更多地讲到。
But why is, but although 秦始皇 was not a Christian, but he was moved by God.
虽然秦始皇不是基督徒, 但神同样可以感动他。
Why was the 罪 written as for against?
为什么?
For opposition.
是四个非放在一块呢?
Or four contradictions.
四个似是而非。
Because do you know there were four contradictions here in Genesis chapter 3?
因为在创世第三章就有四个似是而非之处。
Look at verse 1. The devil says, has God indeed said you shall not eat of every tree of the garden?
魔鬼说,
now this is not true.
不是这样啊,
it was against the word of God. Because God said, you cannot eat of only one tree.
神说只有一棵树的果子不可以吃。
You can eat every tree except one.
所有树可以吃只有这棵不可以。
First contradiction.
这是第一个似是而非。
Second contradiction, verse 2.
第二个四十二分在第二节。 现在夏娃也被吸进来了。
She said, God has said, you shall not eat it, nor shall you touch it, lest you die. Again, not true.
神曾说你们不可吃也不可摸，免得你们死。哎，又不对了。God
allowed them to touch it, just don't eat it.
神可以让他们摸，但不可以吃而已。
Second contradiction.
第二个四十二分。
Third contradiction, verse 4.
第三个四十二分第四节了。
The serpent said to the woman, you will not surely die. That's not true.
神对女人说你们不一定死。不对呀。God
said, you eat it, you will die. That's the third contradiction.
神说吃的那日必定死。这是第三个四十二分了。
Fourth contradiction, verse 5.
而第四个四十二分第五节。
For God knows that in the day you eat of it, your eyes will be open and you will be like God.
因为神知道你们吃的日子眼睛明亮，便如神一样了。
So the devil was trying to tell Eve, well, God is not wanting you to be so powerful like him, so he's stopping you from eating. That's the fourth contradiction.
魔鬼告诉夏娃是神不希望你跟他一样有能力，所以他们不让你吃。这是第四个似是而非了。
So the first time this word 罪 came out,
第一次有这个罪的形状出来的时候,
it was depicting Genesis chapter 3 of the four contradictions that led to the first sin.
哇，这就描绘出创世第三章那四个带出人罪恶的似是而非。Oh,
come on, let's give the Lord a big hand. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Look at verse 7 right now.
你看到第七节,
and the eyes of both of them were open and they knew they were naked.
他们两人眼睛就明亮, 知道自己赤身露体。
Now, how do you write the word naked?
这个赤裸的裸怎么写?
Look at the screen now.
你看到荧幕上的,
notice it got to do with, now watch, it got to do with your clothing, 衣字旁。
注意到跟你穿的衣服有关呢。
Your covering is gone when you eat of the 果子, the fruit.
当你吃那个果子,这个衣服就不见了。
So the first time naked came in, it got to do with covering gone because of a fruit, Genesis.
第一次感到赤裸,就创世纪里面教的,你吃了果子就开始遮蔽自己。Now
look at verse 8.
你看第八节。
And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God from the trees of the garden.
天起了凉风,耶和华神在园中行走,那人和他亲自听见神的声音,就藏在园里的树木中躲避耶和华神的面。Now
Adam went into hiding.
亚当去躲起来了。How
do you write this word hide?
躲这个字怎么写的呢?
Now, his body, 身体,
他的身子,
奶, is
奶,
superimposed to the tree.
藏在木头后头了。So
his body is the tree.
他的身子就好像树木一样了。
In other words, you can't see him. He's hiding behind the tree.
换句话,躲在树木后头,你看不到他了。Man
wasn't hiding. Why? He felt the guilt and shame of sin.
人躲起来为什么? 因为他感受到罪的那个羞愧。
How do you write guilt?
这个愧字怎么写呢?
Well, look at the screen.
你看荧幕上头。
Look, it got to do with heart, 心字旁, your heart.
跟你的心有关嘛, 所以心字旁。
And the devil got into your heart.
啊, 鬼进到心里去啦。
你心里有鬼啊。
有鬼啦。
Now, what happened?
怎么回事?
The devil got into foothold of man's life.
魔鬼在人的生命中占了脚步了。
Well, with the fall of man, sin becomes a part of human nature.
因为人堕落, 罪成为人性的一部分了。
So by the time we come to Genesis chapter 4, the first crime ever committed was recorded.
到了创世纪第四章, 就记载下人类的第一次犯罪。
It has to do with two brothers.
这跟两兄弟有关呢。
Who are the two brothers? Cain and Abel.
哪两兄弟就是该隐跟亚伯。
So what happened?
怎么回事?
Well, Cain killed Abel.
这个哥哥做兄长的该隐杀了弟弟亚伯。
All right. So, 兄弟成为凶手, the brother become murderer.
所以他的兄长成了凶手了。
How do you write murder?
凶手的凶怎么写呢?
Notice it looks almost the same.
哇,长得很像耶,这两个。
And look at Genesis 4 verse 15.
你看到4章15节那里说的?
Cain pled for mercy.
该隐跟神求怜悯。
God, please, you know, please, if you banish me right now, everybody's gonna attack me.
神啊,你把我赶出去,每一个人都可以攻击我了。
God said, all right, I'm going to have a special protection over you.
神说好,我在你身上有特别的保护。
But you'll be marked for life.
可是你一生都带着个记号。
So look at Genesis 4 and verse 15.
你看到4章15节这里,
And the Lord set a mark on Cain, lest anyone find him should kill him.
耶和华给该隐立一个记号, 免得人遇见就杀他。
How do you write the word 凶 or murder?
这个凶恶的凶字怎么写?
It is a man's head or face, and it was marked.
一个人的额头上面做了个记号。
You see, that's murder.
看到没? 凶恶的凶字。
Mark on Cain's head.
就印在该隐的头上的。
Right in ancient times, all the story of creation was recorded in their writings.
所以早在古代所有创造的故事都记在我们的文字里了。
Now we come to the flood in Genesis chapter 7.
来到创世纪第七章，我们看见洪水的事发生。
Look at Genesis chapter 7, verse 7.
你看到第七章第七节这里。
So Noah with his sons, his wife, and his sons' wives went into the ark because of the waters of the flood.
挪亚同他的妻和儿子儿妇都进入方舟躲避洪水。
What is the Chinese word for a big boat?
中文要写船这个字怎么写的?
船. Everybody say 船.
船.
Right. How many of you have written this as a Chinese in primary school? Put up your hands.
有多少人小学学过这个船字的技巧?
See, you're writing this, but you're writing Genesis story and you don't even know.
哇,你每次来写创世纪的故事,你自个儿都不知道了。
How do you write 船? Look, look, 写这里。
船这个字怎么写的? 你看啊。
A 舟, a boat.
啊,这就是一艘船, 舟。
With 8 people, 八。
里面有八口人。
You say, why 8 people in the boat?
诶,怎么船上有八个人啊?
Because chapter 7 and verse 7 says, Noah and his wife, 2 people.
在创世纪七章七节说,挪亚跟他太太两个人了。
3 sons, that makes it 5.
三个儿子,五个了。
And 3 daughter-in-laws, that's 8.
再加三个媳妇多少?八个人。
The first time boat was used, 8 people were inside.
第一次用船的时候,里头就是八个人的。
Recorded in Chinese history.
华人的文字里面就记下来了。
Oh, come on, let's give the Lord another big clap. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now we come to the Tower of Babel. All right, this is the third big major global event. Like 9/11 has to do with a tower.
好像911一样,它跟高塔有关的。
But not because a plane hit the tower.
可是不是飞机飞进去的关系啊。
So we come to Genesis 11.
你看到创世纪11章。
And here the world got wicked again. Look at Genesis 11 and verse 1.
11章1节这里说,
now the whole earth had one language and one speech.
Alright,
and verse 4, they say, come, let us build ourselves a city and a tower whose top is in the heavens. Let us make a name for ourselves, lest we be scattered abroad over the face of the whole earth.
第四节他们说,来吧,我们要建造一座城和一座塔,塔顶通天,为要传扬我们的名,免得我们分散在全地上。
Now, how do you write the word tower in Chinese?
而中文的这个塔字是怎么写的呢?
It's the word ta, everybody say ta.
Ta.
Right? Now, notice how you write it.
注意这个字怎么写?
All the people, 人,
首先全部都是人,
speaking one,
一,
mouth or one language.
口同声的.
People have one speech. This is the Chinese word. Huh.
人众口一声的是什么? 合一的合字.
So when we have one vision, one language, we speak one word, we are united together.
当我们有同样的意象，当我们说同样的语言，我们就是合一在一起的。
But here they were united for something evil.
可是这里的合一是为邪恶的事情。
They were taking grass, 草字头,
拿了草出来，所以有草字头,
and clay, 土字边,
加上土字边的土一起,
and they formed the word 塔,
就形成这个塔字。
So the first time tower is used in Chinese history, it got to do with people in unity together building something.
而人第一次使用塔这个字，就是人们合一在一起要建造一个东西。
Now, look at verse 9.
你看第九节。
Therefore, its name is called Babel, because there the Lord confused the language of all the earth.
因为耶和华在那里变乱天下人的语言，因此那城名叫巴别。Now,
what did you say in Chinese?
中文怎么说的? 变乱。变乱。
Confusion or 乱, how do you write it?
这个混乱的乱字怎么写呢?
It got to do with your tongue.
这跟你的舌头有关啊。
This is the word 舌头 or tongue.
这是舌头的舌字。
And because of tongue, now this word, this character, it is the right leg. It's your right leg.
这个边旁呢，就像人的右腿一样。
It speaks of the right leg scattering in one direction.
代表是从一个方向，用这个右腿把它快散。Confusion. 混乱。
Because of the words, the people were scattering.
因为这些人的言语的关系被赶散出去了。Because
the language was being mixed up.
他们的言语被变乱了。Now,
the Chinese word for scattering is the word 分散。
中文讲到分散这两个字，你看到分散这两个字。
My pronunciation is not so good. I got to learn from Lulu. How do you write the word 分散?
分散这两个字要怎么写呢?
Can you see here? Can you see here?
下面看得到吗?
Everybody turn your neighbor and say, look at pastor, come on.
跟旁边说要看着牧师啊。
Okay. All right, it is the word 八 and the word 刀, a knife.
这个分字上头是个八字，下头是一把刀。
Why is that eight?
为什么写个八呢?
Because there were eight generations leading to the Tower of Babel.
因为从八个世代才数到巴别塔这里来。
And they were all divided by the knife, so there was division.
因此又把刀把他们分开来，让他们分隔出去。Now,
分散，散，散，散，分散。My honey ping is not so good. 分散. Now, look, 分散 is all the people. This is where you get the word 共.
这个呢是共有的共上头那个字。
人民共和国共, right?
Yeah, 那个共字。
And this is 肉字边, flesh.
下头是个肉字边, 所有有血气的。
And this word, Lulu, help me.
这个是扑字旁。
扑字旁, that means followed.
这个是从后跟上的意思。
So look, put them all together.
把它们全部放在一块。
Generations were divided, and all the flesh followed.
这世代被分隔, 所有有血气的跟随而去。
So because of the Tower of Babel,
因为有巴别塔,
all the people were scattered.
所有人被赶散出去。
And one major group went in towards the east and settled in the land of China.
很重要的一组人往东边去，到了中国安定下来。
So they migrated.
因此他们迁移过去了。
Okay, the word migrated or scattered is this word, look.
而中文迁移的这个迁字你看到了。
Now, very interesting.
很有意思啊。
Okay, this is the last space I have. Okay, so everybody look at this last space.
每个人看到最后一个洞了啊。
All right. Now, how do you write this word 迁?
这个迁字要怎么写呢?
It was a big migration. 大.
这是一个很大的迁移, 所以有个大字。
大. And this word, 四.
这个四字。
Which means division.
这个字是分散的意思。
So there was a big division.
一个很大的分散。
Where did it happen from?
从哪儿发生的呢?
From the west.
是在西边发生的。So
Babel, to the Chinese race, is known as the west.
对华人来说，巴别塔是在西边的事情。Remember,
we all have the, you know, the Chinese mythological story of the monkey god. He went to the west.
中国那个很好玩的童话故事叫《西游记》。
All right, where is the west to them? It's not America, it's not England, it is Tibet, it's towards that area.
他们的西方在哪儿?不是美国、英国,是到西藏、印度那儿去。
So Babel to them at that time is the west.
对他们来说,巴别塔就是西边了。
Big division at the west. And as a result, people were scattered against 走字旁。
因为西边这个大型的分散使得人们要走了。
So they all scattered and settled in the land of China.
因为这样的分散, 让他们安定到中国之地。
皇帝 was one of the descendants.
皇帝是他们当一个始祖。
And in his time, the Chinese character was invented.
在那个时候, 中国的文字开始发明出来了。
And all these things was recorded.
这一切都记载下来。
But they didn't just record history.
可是他不光记历史而已。
Remember, 皇帝 worshiped 上帝。
记得吗? 皇帝特别去拜上帝耶。
So there was this concept.
有这样的概念。
That God did not want to forsake relationship with man, although we have fallen into sin.
尽管我们掉入最终,
How many of you know God doesn't want to give up his relationship with us? Amen? So what did God do?
神要做什么呢?
Well, the Old Testament tells you he instituted a system of blood sacrifice.
而旧约告诉我们,
All right, now how do you write the word sacrifice?
这个牺牲献祭的牺字怎么写?
Just a few more, okay, then I'm done.
再几个字就写完了,
All right, yeah. How you write sacrifice?
这个牺牲的牺字怎么写?
Look, sacrifice.
你看这个字啊?
You say, ah, pastor, very hard.
牧师,这个字很难呢。
Okay, let me see. Well, what did God do? The book of Hebrews tells us,
神是怎么做的? 希伯来书告诉我们,
Leviticus tells us,
利未记也说了,
God says, take the cow.
神说把你们牛带来,
Take the lamb.
把你们的羊带来,
but it got to be without blemish.
可是是最美, 没有残疾的哦,
Sew. Perfect.
是完美的,
kill them with a spear. 割,
用刀割把它给杀了,
offer as a sacrifice.
把它献上为祭。
Can you see the whole concept of the blood sacrifice is already in this one word? Especially use the sacrifice of a baby lamb.
特别要献上是羊羔的祭。
So how you write a 羊羔 or 羔羊?
这个羔字怎么写呢?
You take a lamb, put it through fire.
你把羊放在火上头。
So the concept is take a lamb, sacrifice it, burn it.
所以概念就是把羊带来，牺牲它，烧了它。
Then what do you do? Take the blood.
你还要做什么? 你还要盛他的血。
Do you know the original Chinese word for blood is this picture of a vessel with a drop of blood inside?
你知道中国古字的血字是长这个样, 一个器皿里头一个点。
This is the vessel of a cup, a Chinese cup with blood inside.
这是一个中国杯子的形状里面放的是血。
But then it was changed.
可是后来改了这个字呢?
It was changed to this word, 血。
慢慢演化成今天我们所写这个血字。
Now how do you write 血?
这个血怎么写的?
血 is actually, now watch, it is blood, a dash of blood, in a vessel, mean, this is the word, this vessel.
你把一滴血放在器皿的皿里头。
Now you say, this is too hard. No, you're singing this all the time in the Chinese church.
你说,哎呦,这个很难了,没有,我们华文教会一天到晚唱的嘞。
Since when?
什么时候有唱啊?
Well, remember the song Above All Else?
你记得我们唱那首歌 Above All Else 吗?
You know, Ellie comes every week.
Ellie 每个礼拜来啊。
So imagine I'm Ellie right now, long hair.
假设我现在是长头发的Ellie啊。
You know, I... Tall.
高挑,窈窕的身材。
Always sing like this, Ellie.
每次唱歌都是这样的。
Here I stand, 相服于你。 Here I stand,
渴慕于你。
言成为你起名 Every week you're singing it.
每个礼拜你在唱嘞。
The whole concept of blood in a vessel.
整个血盛在器皿里的概念。
Bring before the presence of God.
要带到神的面前。
For the forgiveness of our sin.
来赦免我们的罪。
All right. Ultimately, Jesus Christ is the Lamb of God, sent by the Lord, sent by God Himself. To be the Savior of the world. Hallelujah.
而最终耶稣基督神的羔羊是神亲自拆下来成为我们的献祭。
Come on, give the Lord a big clap.
那就热烈的拍掌。
And you know, this, he came to give us righteousness.
他来是要赐公义给我们。
And righteousness is this word, lamb over me.
而义这个字就是羊在我之上。
Lamb?
羊,
over me.
在我之上。
So notice sacrifice always got to do with lamb.
注意到牺牲一直跟羊有关呢。
Now, remember many people say, and you heard it before, what about, you know, you guys are Christians. You know, you say God loves the world, but what about ancient China?
很多人在说, 哎呀, 你们今天到晚说神爱中国, 这个, 可是你看, 古代中国人怎么办?
What about all this ancient China?
那些古代的中国人呢?
I got so fed up of people talking to me like this.
每次人家这样跟我讲,都受不了了。
The next time somebody talks to you, especially during this Chinese New Year, you tell them this, what I'm going to tell you right now.
下次有人这样问你,特别农历年的时候,你就把我现在要跟你讲的告诉他们啊。
This word, thousands of years old.
这个字已经几千年的历史了。
Longer before Jesus even came.
早在耶稣第一次降临之前就有了。
How do you write this word?
这个字怎么写的?
Originally, you take a lamb.
一开头你拿一只羊来,
and you use your hand, 手这边,
用你的手,
you take a spear and pierce him.
拿把刀戳进去,
a spear.
一把刀割戳进去的。
So, the Chinese already prophesied.
中文已经预言了,
God will bring his lamb.
神要赐下他的羊,
and people will take a spear and with their hands pierce him. And you know that happened on Calvary.
人要拿着刀割戳进他的肋旁, 这就在十字架上发生了。
Can you imagine thousands of years before Jesus came?
发现到耶稣来几千年前呢?
Even his death was already prophesied in Chinese writing.
他的死亡都已经在中文文字里面预言出来了。
Now, today, my boy, Dayan, is called Kang Yi.
今天我的儿子的名字就叫康义。
But in Singapore, we write in this simplified format.
可是新加坡我们写的中文是简体字的中文。
But notice, even this word is fantastic.
即使这个简体字都很漂亮啊。
It means the blood
代表有一滴血
on the cross.
躺在十字架上。
The blood on the cross.
十字架上的血。
It could mean the blood in the vessel before God.
它可能是在神面前器皿里的血,
but also mean the blood ultimately they'll be splattered on the cross of Calvary.
可是也代表最终在各个他十字架上流出的血。
So the Chinese unknowingly were expecting.
而华人不知不觉中不断在期待。
Long time ago.
好久好久以前,
long before Taoism and Confucianism and Buddhism came.
早在道教、佛教、儒教进来之前,
invaded in their history. This concept that God will one day send an ultimate Lamb of God that will die on the cross, pierce into the side, and his blood will be a sacrifice for our sin.
有一天神赐下他的羔羊,死在十字架上,身旁被刺破, 让他能够带下他的宝血,拯救我们的罪。
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
So can you imagine?
你可以想象哦,
you grow up writing all these words.
你出去外面写这些字,
and unknowingly, you're writing the history of God into your heart.
不知不觉把神的历史写在你心里嘞。
Subconsciously,
潜意识当中,
you are rehearsing the story of the Bible.
你一直重述圣经的故事。
So John 3:16 say, whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life or eternal life.
在约翰福音3:16节说, 凡信他的不至灭亡反得永生。
The word eternal life or yong in the ancient writing is this.
永字的古字是长这样的。
It says, it means when the Lamb comes, he will wash you like water, all your sins away.
这羊来能够像水一样洗净你所有的罪。
Today, we use this word yong, which also means the same thing.
今天我们的字变成这个永字也是同样的意思。
When the blood comes, he will wash you like water, and all your sins will be washed as white as snow. Hallelujah.
当这血流出来,它像水一样洗净你一切污秽的罪。Hallelujah.
You want to clap? Give the Lord a big clap.
我就热烈地拍掌。
How are you saved today?
你今天是怎么得救的?
You are saved through faith.
因着信而得救。
So Romans 10 verse 8 says,
罗马书第十章第八节说,
with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation.
人口里承认就必得救。
So what is faith?
信是什么?
Faith is when a man
是当一个人
uses his mouth to confess.
使用他的水说出这个话。
And that confession will bring to faith that will lead to grace, that lead to salvation.
而且说的话带出信心, 带出得救的救恩来。
Oh, come on, give the Lord a big clap right now. Isn't this amazing?
这是不是很神奇?
So you say, wow, never realized this.
你说,哎呦,我都不知道这个嘞。
So the next time somebody tells you,
下一次有人跟你说,
hey, you're Chinese.
哎,你是华人。
Shouldn't you be this, this, this?
你应该做这种教的吗?
You say, no.
你说不,
long before this, this, this,
早在这些月以前,
we have all this.
我们有这个啦。
They say, oh, you embrace an American faith.
哎呀，你信的是美国人的信仰。
You embrace the faith of George W. Bush or Obama.
哎呀，你信的是布什跟奥巴马的信仰。
You say no.
你说不啊。
You say it's not true.
不是这样啊。
You say it a long time ago.
好久好久以前。
Even as a little boy and little girl.
即使我是小孩的时候。
As I learned to write all these words.
我就在写这些字了。
The story of God.
神的故事。
From Genesis.
从创世纪。
To the flood.
到洪水。
To Babel.
到巴别塔。
To the sacrificial system.
到整个献祭的系统。
To the coming of Christ dying on the cross.
到基督死在十字架上。
To the way I can be blessed.
到我怎么样蒙福。
To what faith is all about.
讲到信心。
God is the God of the Chinese people.
神是华人的神。
I'm going back to my roots. I'm going back to my culture. You want to clap? Give the Lord a big clap. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How many of you want to learn even more amazing thing about God in ancient China?
You got to
come back next week. I want to close the night by going to Acts 17.
最后结束，我们要看到《使徒行传》17章。
Acts 17.
使徒行传17章。
I know this Chinese New Year, many of you have many stories to tell now.
我知道这个农历年很多人有故事要说了哈。
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In Acts 17 and verse 22.
使徒行传17章20节。
Acts 17 and verse 22.
使徒行传17章22节。
Next week when you come.
下个星期你来。
I'm going to tell you an amazing story. You know, my dad named me after a Chinese emperor.
我爸爸给我取名的时候就叫一个中国的皇帝取的。
His name is Kangxi.
他的名字叫康熙。
康熙皇帝。
清朝的康熙皇帝。
So I asked my dad one day when we were in Taiwan and we were in the Chinese Museum.
啊，有一个我们在台湾故宫博物院的时候，我就问我爸爸了。
I said, and there was a lot of stuff about. 康熙,
哇, 里面很多康熙皇帝的收藏哦。
And one of the things that was on display was that Kangxi was a convert. He was a Christian.
哎, 在这个当中哦, 看到一段哦, 讲到康熙信了主哦。
And how he was praising God.
他怎么样赞美神, 他是个基督徒哦。
So next week I'll tell you more about him.
下个星期我跟你多讲一点。
The greatest emperor in China, a believer of Jesus Christ.
而中国最伟大的皇帝是相信耶稣基督的信徒。
And I asked my dad, I said, why didn't you name my Why didn't you write my Chinese name exactly like him?
我就问我爸了，你干嘛不让我的名字跟他完全一模一样呢？
If I do that, all your friends will laugh at you.
他说如果我这样，你所有朋友都会笑你啦。
But anyway, next week I'll tell you more about Kangxi, and it's an amazing story.
下个星期我会跟你更多讲一点康熙神奇的故事。
So next week no more writing lessons, okay?
下个星期不要再上这个写字课了哈。
But I tell you a very exciting story.
非常兴奋的故事哦。
But in Acts 17 and verse 22.
实际上17章22节。
Paul came to Athens.
保罗来到雅典。
And Paul did not scold the people for the idolatry.
保罗没有骂这些人拜偶像哎。
He says, "Men of Athens, I perceive that in all things you are very religious."
他说，雅典人呐， 我看你们凡事很敬畏鬼神。
And then he says in verse 22.
22节这里说，
"I was passing through and considering the object of your worship." And I've even found an altar with this inscription to the unknown God.
我游行的时候观看你们所敬拜的，玉座一座坛上面写着未世之神。
Therefore, the one whom you worship without knowing him, I proclaim to you.
你们所不认识而敬拜的，我现在告诉你们。
I tell you, this is our job.
我告诉你，这就是我们的工作。This
is our job in China.
这是我们在中国的工作。
In Taiwan.
在台湾。
Here in Singapore.
在新加坡这里。
And all throughout the Chinese-speaking world.
也到所有华人的世界里头。
Chinese people are like the men of Athens.
华人就好像雅典人一样。
We are very religious.
我们是很有宗教性的。
We are very superstitious.
是很迷信的。
We are scared of ghosts and gui all the time.
哇，一天到晚疑神疑鬼，怕来怕去的。
You know, everything is ghosts here and ghosts there.
哇，这个也是鬼，那个也是鬼的。
You know, 死鬼，洋鬼。
醉鬼、酒鬼、脏鬼。
You know, we are very religious people.
我们都是很敬畏鬼神的。And
what we need to do is point them, because Chinese people are searching for God.
因为华人一直在寻求神。And
we got to tell them the God that you've been searching for.
我们要告诉他你在找的是哪位神。
It's the same God, the first emperor of China worship is the God 上帝。
就是中国人第一个皇帝所敬拜的上帝。
You don't know his name. But to the Hebrew, he is called Yahweh or Jehovah.
但在希伯来人称他为亚威或耶和华。
To the Christian, he is called Jesus Christ.
对基督徒来说，他叫耶稣基督。
And to the Chinese people from the beginning, he is called 上帝。
而对华人一开头就叫他上帝。And
look at verse 26.
你看26节。
And he has made from one blood every nation of men to dwell on all the face of the earth.
他从一本造出万族的人住在全地上。
And has determined the pre-appointed times and the boundaries of habitation.
并且预先定准他们的年限和所住的疆界。
So even while you may not know God,
即使你还不认识神,
God has already included you into His plan to save you. He wants to reveal Himself to you. He wants to tell you His story. And tell your roots and your cultural heritage. And tell you that He wants to bless you and He has a good plan for you to make you the head and not the tail. To prosper you. Oh, give the Lord a big hand. Look at verse 27 now.
你看到27节说,
so that they should seek the Lord in the hope that they might grope for Him and find Him, though He is not far from each one of us.
要叫他们寻求神,
so God is not far. He's just a breath away. Do you know the moment you were born, for many of you?
你知道很多的人你出生的那一刻,
how many of you here are Chinese? Lift up your hand.
有多少在座是华人的请举手。
How many of you learned to write Chinese as a young boy or girl? Put up your hand.
多少小时候学过中文字的?
As a young child.
你从小,
even when you write the word 天, a simple word, God was trying to reveal Himself to you.
即使你写天这么简单的字, 神都要显明他自己给你看。
I'm the one bigger than all the big on the earth. When you write all these words, God is near you, trying to show you.
当你写这些字,
come to me, all those that are heavy laden.
那些劳苦担重,
you see, He's orchestrating all the human events. Even the bad times, even the economic recession.
即使是逆境经济不景气的时候,
so that every one of us have the greatest chance to know Him and to experience Him and to encounter Him as the true Savior and God of all the earth. Hallelujah.
有每一个人有最好的机会亲自来遇见认识经历,
come on, you want to clap, give the Lord a big clap tonight. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, give the Lord a big hand. Musicians, come up right now.
Hallelujah.
How many of you tonight suddenly realize, hey, God really has been trying to show Himself to me since I was born? Put up your hands right now.
Yeah.
Can we trust Him then?
我们可不可以信靠他?
Can we trust Him? Who is so interested in us? Can we trust this God, this Heavenly Father, to take care of us when we go through difficult times? Of course you can. Even in this economic recession, can we trust in Him? This God who wants to reveal Himself, let me tell you, what does He want to show you? He wants to show you that He's Jehovah Jireh, the God your provider. He wants to show you that He's El Shaddai, He's the God of more than enough. He wants to show you that when the whole world is going down, you can keep on going up. Then you say, oh, but how? You know, I've been retrenched.
你说怎么办?
Every problem is a new opportunity. For God to explode His blessings into your life. For you to discover new talents that will take you into the next realm. Tonight, I want you to begin to pray. God, I want to trust you to take care of me. Well, how many of you also secondly tonight? You can suddenly you believe and you have faith. Man, if God is the God of the Chinese people, then my family can get saved. My grandparents, my father, my mother, my brother, my sister. Long before these things came in, He is the God of China. Now you realize why the greatest revival is happening in China right now. Because inbuilt in the Chinese culture is this hunger for this one true God. So that is why when you talk to Chinese people, you don't need to get into deep theology. You don't need to explain, like, if you got to talk to, you know, other parts of the world. Simply tell the Chinese, He's your God. He loves you. He wants to bless you. And everywhere you go in the Chinese world, they open their hearts and say, I want to be a believer. Because this is like going back to our roots. This is going back to our real culture. Tonight, let's all stand up on our feet right now. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let's just lift our hands and just begin to worship this great God. I mentioned that for most of us Chinese, the moment we become Christians, very often we are made to feel that we have done something wrong. We are made to feel as if we have embraced a totally foreign Western religion. That somehow we abandon our roots, our culture, and our Chinese heritage. Because if you are Chinese, many people make us feel, well, you're supposed to be either a Buddhist, a Taoist, or a Confucianist.
因为如果你是华人，很多人觉得理所当然，你要就是儒家，要就是佛教，不是道教徒。
But the truth of the story is China has a 4,500-year history.
然而事情的真相是，中国总共的历史有4,500多年。
So this is the year 2009.
这里是2009年。
And this would be, say, 0 BC.
这是公元的0年。
China has a history of 4,500 years. It is as old as the Hebrew race. It is among the most enduring and unbroken civilization in the history of mankind. But the truth of the matter is, in the entire history, those great religions of Taoism, Buddhism, and Confucianism came fairly recently.
可是在整个历史当中，我们所谓的这些宗教，佛家、道家、儒家也好，都是非常新近才发生的。
Taoism came on the 6th BC.
道教的出现在公元前6世纪。
Confucianism and Buddhism came 5th BC.
而佛教跟儒家的出现大概是公元前5世纪。
So the big question here is this.
这里一个很重要的问题是,
what about this period of time?
这一段时间呢?
Almost 2,500 years.
将近2,500年哦。
What did the Chinese people believe in?
中国人相信的是什么呢?
And history or historical documents tell us they didn't worship idols.
而历史的记录告诉我们，他们拜的不是偶像。
They worship a God called 上帝。
他们在崇拜的是这位上帝。
And the word 上帝 means the most high king or the king who lives in heaven.
上帝的字面意思就是至高的君王居住在天上。
So the Chinese worship the only one and supreme sovereign God.
因此华人在拜的是那个独一真神，是至高的主。
And when you study his character and his nature and works, you find that they were totally similar to the God of the Old Testament Bible.
可是当你研究这个上帝，他的性情，他的品格，他的工作的时候，你发现他跟圣经里面讲到的神一模一样。
But while the Hebrew people call him Yahweh or Jehovah,
而希伯来人把他称之为亚伯或耶和华神,
the Chinese call him 上帝。
而华人把他称之为上帝。
Now in China, the first dynasty with actual written records and documents is the Shang Dynasty.
在中国有真正文字历史记载的第一个朝代叫商朝。
That means those historical documents are still available today in museums and libraries.
当时所记下的历史记载，到今天在一些博物馆里面还可以看得到。
And this was roughly the same period as the time of Exodus all the way to the book of Judges.
而商朝的时代就像圣经当中出埃及记到士师记的年代。
So while Moses and Joshua were leading the people into the promised land,
当摩西跟约书亚把百姓带进到应许之地的时候,
you have the Shang Dynasty in China.
中国这边就有商朝了。 Now
both Confucius in his five classics and Sima Qian's historical records confirm that the Shang people worship 上帝。
不管是孔子的五经也好，司马迁记的史记也好，里面都证实当时商朝的人拜的就是这位上帝。
The 上帝 that they worship has sovereignty over the nations. Like Daniel chapter 2 in the Bible, he removes kings and he raises up kings. This 上帝 governs the rain, the wind, and all the elements of nature. And they call him in their documents the Lord of the harvest.
而在他们的记载里面说,
Isn't that interesting?
这是不是很有意思?
Jesus says that you got to pray to the Lord of the harvest, Jehovah God.
耶稣说,
the Chinese call their 上帝 also the Lord of the harvest. The Shang Dynasty was later conquered by the Zhou Dynasty. And instead of calling God Shang Di, the Zhou people call him Shang Tian. And the word Tian means of everything that is big on the earth, He's higher than they all.
而你看到这个天字讲的什么意思? 在地上一切伟大事物之上一个更高的那一位。
So he is El Elyon, the Most High God. The God Most High, hallelujah.
是最高的真神, hallelujah.
So while we speak it, or we say in English, Oh my God.
我们在英文里面常常讲的是, Oh my God.
You go to China, you go to Taiwan, they love to say, 天啊.
如果到台湾中国去的话,听得说, Oh, 我的天啊.
It's the same thing, it's referring to God.
同样讲的都是神。
It was during this period where the phrase mandate of heaven was widely used. In other words, they totally believe in the sovereignty and supreme authority of God.
换句话说,
so to the Chinese, 上帝 or 天 refers to the same person.
因此对华人来说,
China's greatest historian Sima Qian recorded in historical records.
中国历史上最伟大的历史学家司马迁在他的史记里面记载着说：“上帝者，天之别名也，神无二主。”That
means 上帝 is another name for 天. The spirits do not have two lords.
上帝就是天的另外一个名字，这世上没有另外两个主了。Now
we got to answer the big question.
现在有一个很重要的问题要问了。How
can we be 100% sure that this 上帝 is the same Jehovah God of the Bible?
我们怎么能够百分之百确定这位上帝就是我们在圣经中讲的这位耶和华神呢?
Well, 上帝 was mentioned 175 times in the Chinese classics.
在中国经书当中,上帝提到了175次。
So you don't need to second guess, but you have a very accurate idea who he's like.
你不需要臆测,你有非常清楚的概念知道到底这位上帝是谁。
Well, in the classic of poetry, it says that 上帝 is sovereign.
在《诗经》当中提到，上帝是有绝对的主权的。这里说：“商之孙子，其利不义。上帝既命侯于周服。”Now
this means the descendants of Shang were in number more than hundreds of thousands.
这里的意思说，商的后裔有许多许多的人数。But
when 上帝 gave the command, they became subject to the Zhou Dynasty.
但上帝一发命令，所有都要服于周朝。So
God has all authority over nations, which is what the Bible teaches.
因此神在所有列国中他是掌权的，就像圣经教的。And
then they believe 上帝 is all powerful.
之后他们相信上帝是全能的。在这里他说，渺渺昊天，无不可顾。That
means mysterious almighty heaven is able to strengthen anything.
这奥秘全能的天能够兼顾所有的事物。
Well, the God of the Bible is omnipotent.
我们圣经的神也是全能的神。The
Bible says, is there anything too hard for God?
圣经说在神岂有难成的事吗?
No, our Lord God, there is nothing too hard for thee. Amen.
在我们的神没有任何难成的事。Amen.
Come on, give the Lord a big hand.
为主热烈的拍掌。
The Chinese believe 上帝 is all-knowing, he's omniscient.
华人相信上帝是全知无所不知的。这里他说：“王以上帝，灵下有赫，监视四方，求名之末。”That
means Almighty 上帝, you come to us in your majesty, you discern all that is happening for the peace of the people.
他说：“全能的上帝啊，你君临天下，你能分辨神百姓当中一切发生的事。”
So there is no secret that their 上帝 wouldn't know, he knows all things.
因此没有什么秘密是上帝不知道的, 他什么都了解。
Well, they believe 上帝 is ever present.
同时他们相信上帝是无所不在的。 这里他说, 上帝是其, 地命是与久违。
That means 上帝 is revered because his will extends to the nine limits. That means he's everywhere.
这里讲到神的旨意是能够扩展到所有的境界，各处都有的。
And mind you, this is written by Confucius himself.
哎，这是孔子自个儿写的文字。
And they believe 上帝 is love.
同时他们相信上帝就是爱哦。这里他说，为天惠民，为必奉天。So
heaven loves the people, the ruler should honor heaven.
上天爱他的百姓，而君主当尊崇天。
Let me tell you, there are not many major religions that believe in a God of love.
我告诉你，没有什么大的宗教相信神是爱的。
They do believe in powerful gods who people should fear.
他们相信可能是全能的神，是百姓要敬畏他。But
only the God of the Bible is the God of love.
然而只有圣经中提到的神是因爱的神。A
God of mercy.
是怜悯的神。And
then there are other records that say 上帝 is eternal.
还有其他的记录，讲到上帝是永恒的。He's
righteous, he's just, he's holy.
他是公义、公平、圣洁的。He's
compassionate and full of grace.
他是怜悯、充满恩典的。He's
faithful, he's wise, he is a good God.
他是信实、智慧、美善的神。So
when you look at all these attributes, you can only come to one logical conclusion.
当你看到所有的属性之后，只能得到一个合理的答案。The
上帝 that the Chinese believe in is surely the same Jehovah God of the Old Testament in the Bible.
中国人相信这个上帝确实就是圣经旧约里面相信以色列人神。They
believe the same God that we Christians believe in.
他们相信神就跟我们基督徒相信的完全一样。Let's
give the Lord a big clap for that.
为主热烈的拍掌。He
reveals himself to all.
他向众人显明自己。In
Beijing, China today,
在今天中国的北京,
the most beautiful and elegant of all the ancient constructions is the Temple of Heaven.
一栋最美丽的中国古式建筑就是天坛。It
was built in 1420 during the Ming Dynasty.
这大概1420年在明朝的时候建的。It
is much bigger than the Forbidden City.
它的面积比紫禁城更大。And
contains the largest altar in the history of the world for the worship of heaven.
而里面有全世界最大的一座祭天的圣坛。For
the worship of a singular God.
是要来祭拜这位独一真神的。
Now, many people consider it today a Taoist temple.
很多人今天以为那是一座道教的庙。But
the truth is, the altar of heaven traces all the way back to the beginning 2,500 years ago.
可是你了解天坛它真正崇拜的真意，可以追溯到4,500年前最早的时候。Again,
Taoism started in 6 BC.
道教是在公元前6世纪才有哎。But
all the way back to the beginning, already all throughout their history, they have the altar and the temple of heaven.
可是早在最开始 4,500多年以前 就已经有这样天坛祭天的常用了。
And unlike typical Chinese temples,
而且它不像一般中国的庙宇哦,
there is no idol or images inside.
在天坛里面没有任何的偶像。
Now, if you have been to temples, you know every temple has statues and idols.
你到任何庙里面去看到, 里面都有这些雕塑的偶像在。
But when you go to Beijing, to the temple of heaven, not a single idol or a graven image.
可是如果你到北京天坛去看, 里面空空如, 也没有任何的偶像存在。
In fact, all throughout China's 4,500 years history, there is no picture or images of 上帝 ever in the history.
实际上中国4,500年历史里面从来没有任何看见上帝雕刻的偶像或画的图画的。Because
like the Hebrew of the Bible, the Chinese understood the first commandment.
因为就像圣经中的希伯来人一样，中国人了解神诫命当中要求的。You
shall not make for yourself a calf image. Hallelujah.
你不可为自己雕刻偶像。Hallelujah.
Oh, give the Lord a big clap for that. Amen.
热烈的拍掌。Amen.
Now, in the temple of heaven is the altar of heaven.
在这个天坛当中呢，有这个祭天的圣坛在。
Whose sacrifices was offered to 上帝 or Tian for almost 4,500 years.
4,500多年来，他们在那里来崇拜这位上帝或者天。
All 18 dynasties throughout China's history have always sacrificed to 上帝 at this altar.
中国18个朝代下来，每一个朝代都向天献祭的。
And depending on where the emperor set up their capital city, There you find the altar of heaven.
啊, 那里就会有他们祭天的坛了。
So if the capital was in Xi'an, then the altar of heaven would be in Xi'an.
如果京城在西安, 当时祭天坛就在西安。
If the capital was in Nanjing, then the altar would be at Nanjing.
如果他的京城在南京, 那他们祭天的坛就在南京。
All right, now it's in Beijing.
现在是在北京那儿,
because the emperors of the past set up their capital in Beijing.
因为在明朝的是皇帝, 他们的京城设在北京。
They always built an altar of heaven for the Most High God.
他们每一次都为至高神设立着祭天的坛。
Where did the Chinese learn this from?
华人从哪儿学到这些的?
Go with me to Genesis chapter 8.
我们来看创世纪第八章。
Now you got to remember the Chinese race is the descendants of Shem, one of Noah's three sons.
你要明白,华人是挪亚三个儿子当中闪的后裔。
Very interesting.
很有意思的。
Because Abraham was also a descendant of Shem.
因为亚伯拉罕同时也是闪的后裔。
All right, so the Israelites and the Chinese, we share a common heritage.
因此以色列人跟华人几乎可以说有同样的同源。
Although today, our color of our skin is very different.
虽然今天我们的肤色差别蛮大的。
Now, what was the first thing Noah did when he came out of the ark?
记得挪亚从方舟出来之后做的第一件事是什么?
Remember, God sent a great flood and it rained for 40 days and 40 nights.
记得当时有极大的洪水下了40昼夜的雨。
At the end of the flood, Noah came out of the ark.
在洪水之后, 挪亚从方舟里出来了。
And look at the first thing he did in verse 20.
你在20节看见他做的第一件事情。
Then Noah built an altar to the Lord and took of every clean animal and every clean bird and offered burnt offerings on the altar.
挪亚为耶和华筑了一座坛，拿各类洁净的牲畜、飞鸟献在坛上为燔祭。
So he built an altar, he took clean animals, and he offered sacrifices to God.
因此他筑了一座坛，带着洁净的牲畜来，在这里为神献祭牺牲。
Now you must remember, where was Noah in the history over here?
你要了解挪亚在历史当中是从哪里开始的？
Just few hundred years before
2500 BC.
Just one or two generations before that.
不过呢,之前一两代的事情。
Now, after Noah, you have the episode with the Tower of Babel.
在挪亚之后发生了巴别塔的事件。
And then all the people were scattered. And God confused their language, because God confused their language.
神变乱百姓的语言，因此所有的人民四散到各地去了。Well,
the Chinese migrated to the east and settled in the land that is known as China today.
而当时这一族人往东边迁移到今天的中国这儿定居安定下来。But
the practice of offering holy sacrifices or bring holy offerings, well, they remembered all the way from Abel to Noah.
然而一直从亚伯挪亚传下来向神献上神圣祭物的事情一直在他们的记忆当中。
So it was continued among the ancient Chinese.
在古代中国人当中一直持续下来的。司马迁
in his classic historical records,
司马迁在他的史记当中记载着,
he recorded that China's first king, 皇帝,
记录了中国第一个真正的君主皇帝,
he went to Taishan or Mao Tai.
他到了中国的泰山,
this is in Shandong province.
在中国山东省那儿,
he built an altar and offered sacrifices to 上帝.
在那里筑一座坛为上帝献祭。
So no worship of idols.
没有拜偶像哦。
Only the worship of one supreme God.
而是敬拜着独一的真神。
And that was what? 4,500 years ago.
这是大概4,500年以前的事儿。
司马迁 recorded that this ritual was always done at the outskirt of the city.
而司马迁也记载,这样的仪式是要在城之外的郊野来做。在这里他说,古者天子下,公卿礼祀上帝于郊,古曰郊。So
in ancient times, the son of heaven of the Xia dynasty personally and reverentially sacrificed to 上帝 at the border, and that's why it is called the border sacrifice.
在古代,夏朝的天子是亲自敬畏的,到郊野为上帝献祭,因此称为郊祭。Everybody
say border sacrifice.
Border sacrifice.
Why? Because the altar and the offerings were made at the border of the country. Now, Confucius considered the border sacrifice the most important activity of man.
而孔子认为这个交祭是人类所有活动当中最重要的一个礼仪。
This was what Confucius wrote.
因此孔子在中庸里面写着说, 交涉之礼所以是上帝也。
That means the ceremonies of the celestial and terrestrial sacrifices are those by which man serves 上帝。
他说在郊野所敬拜献祭的事情是为了侍奉上帝。
So let me tell you how they do the ceremony.
让我教教你他们怎么样做这个献祭的。
And you'll find it's so similar to the Old Testament rituals.
你发现哦, 跟旧约的礼仪非常相近哦。
5 days before the ceremony,
在献祭前五天,
all animals to be sacrificed must be inspected, and they got to be firstborn without blemish and must be totally clean.
而在前五天所有献祭的牲畜带到这边来检查，所有牲畜是头生而且没有任何残疾。
And this was exactly what God required in the Old Testament.
这正是神在旧约里面要求的。
Firstborn without spot, without blemish.
没有残疾的头生的归给神。
Now how did the ancient Chinese, how did they know what 上帝 or their God wanted?
可是古代的华人怎么知道上帝要这样的？
They have remembrance of Abel.
因为他们还记得亚伯。
Abel lived only about 8 to 9 generations before them.
亚伯在他们之前大概八九代的事情。
They remember Noah.
他们记得挪亚。
Who's just 1 or 2 generations before.
也不过几代前的人而已。
Now, 3 days before the ceremony,
而在祭祀前三天呢?
All right, 3 days before the ceremony, the emperor would go on a total fast.
祭祀前三天, 皇帝要完全的禁食,
to sanctify his mind, his soul, and his body.
让他的灵魂, 心意跟身体,
and during this time, he is to seek 上帝.
而这段时间他是要来寻求上帝的。
Now, the day before the sacrifice,
就在献祭前一天呢?
The emperor comes in and began to wash his hands in a basin.
皇帝要先为自己洁净, 要洗濯。
All right, he comes before a tablet with the most holy inscription.
要来到这个石碑前, 上面刻着最重要, 最神圣的文字。
And the inscription says, 王天上帝, the supreme lord of the harvest.
上面刻的字是, 皇天上帝, 是至高掌权的主。
In all of China, this is the name above all names.
在全中国, 这是超乎万民之上的名。
The emperor fell to the ground, prostrate himself before this name to worship 上帝。
皇帝要在这个名字之前, 俯伏于地, 开始来敬拜这位上帝。
On the day of the sacrifice,
而献祭当天呢?
The emperor wakes up early in the morning.
清早皇帝要起来。
He will wash his face and hand in a golden basin, just like the priest would do at the laver.
他会在金盆里面洗手洗脸, 就好像祭司在洗桌盆里面洗桌一样。
Incense would be burnt.
要烧香的。
And then, just like a church service, he would sing songs of sacrifices and praise and worship unto 上帝.
而之后呢, 就好像我们教会聚会一样, 他们要向上帝唱各样献祭感恩赞美的歌。
If you think in City Harvest Church we sing for a long time, they sang even longer.
你觉得陈世峰唱歌唱很久，他们唱得更久嘞。
Every week we sing 4 to 5 songs.
每个礼拜我们才唱4、5首歌。
They would sing at least 12 songs.
他们一唱最少12首。
Go with me to Genesis chapter 1.
我们来看创世纪第一章。
All the songs they sang contain similar truths that can be found in the Bible.
他们所唱的歌里面的真理，几乎在圣经中就找到类似的情况。
Now take this one song, the song of beginning peace. This is our second song in the list.
你看到其中的一个例子就是元和之曲，这是他们歌单当中的第二首歌。这里他说：“地必阴阳兮，造化彰，神生七正兮，精华光，元父方在兮，照物康，辰感其报兮，百阴地曰黄。”
Now this is just like the first chapter of Genesis.
这好像创世纪第一章里面一样。
He says, "Lord, D, when you separated the yin and the yang, that means the heavens and the earth."
他说：“主地啊，当你分辨阴阳，这是天地的时候。”
Your creative work had begun.
整个创造的工作开始了。
Oh, you did produce, O Spirit, the 7 elements of sun, moon, and 5 planets. Now, that was what the Chinese understood of the heavens in those days.
他说：“神灵啊，你创造了日月跟5颗另外的星球，这是当时中国人对天文的理解。”
Their beautiful and brilliant lights lit up the circular sky and square earth.
这美丽的光华照亮了圆的天方的地。
All things were good. I, your servant, thank you fearfully, and while I worship, present this memorial to you, O D, calling you sovereign.
而这一切俊都美好，我身为你的仆人，在这里哪里敢说报答你这一切暴躁，因为你一切所造的是何等的伟大。
This is just like Genesis chapter 1.
这就跟创世纪第一章讲的一样。
God separated the heavens and the earth.
神分开了天地。
And then God created the sun, the moon, and the planets.
神也创造了太阳、月亮各样的星星。
And then he said, let there be light for day, and let there be darkness for night.
他说白天要有光，晚上是黑暗。
And then he proclaimed everything to be good.
同时宣告一切是美好的。I
mean, just Genesis chapter 1.
就是创世纪第一章嘛。
And then there's a song, 修和歌, which was pretty amazing.
而另外一首修和之曲也是非常神奇的。这里他说：“地垂听兮，意若倾；子侄拥美兮，无由身。侧表贺见兮，太昊世尊；近臣玉帛兮，宴贺宏人。”The
first line is amazing.
第一行非常神奇。
It says, "You have promised, O D, to hear us, for you are our Father."
他说：“天地，你应许要垂听我们，因你是我们的父亲。”Do
you know only the God of the Bible among all the major religions in the world is considered a heavenly Father?
你知道世界主要宗教当中，只有我们圣经中的神被我们认定他是天上的父。Again,
there are many great religions in the world.
世界上有很多伟大的宗教。All
of them would teach us to do good things.
大家都是教我们做善事。Do
unto others what you want to be done to you.
你要人如何待你，就如何待人。Every
religion would teach that.
每一个宗教都这样教导。
But every religion looked to their God as someone who is powerful and to be feared.
而每一个宗教看待他们的神是非常有能力，非常可怕的。
Only the Christian God or the God of the Bible is known as a wonderful heavenly Father, and the Chinese believe in that of their 上帝.
只有基督教的神，我们圣经里面的神是天上美好的天父，而华人相信上帝是我们的父亲.
After they have sung about a dozen songs,
在我们唱完12首歌之后,
the animals are now ready or were now ready to be sacrificed.
现在预备要把动物带来献祭了.
But along the way to be slain, they have to pass through a tunnel called the Gate of Hell or 鬼门关.
可是在他们能够上坛之前，要先经过这段隧道，被称之为鬼门关。
In other words, the Chinese understood this.
换句话说，华人明白一点。
The lambs, the goats, and the bulls had taken the penalty of death for the sin of all mankind.
这些牛啊羊啊，是为人类所有的罪承担着罪的死亡代价。
That is exactly what the Bible taught in the Old Testament.
这正是圣经在旧约教我们呢。
Every time when they come before the Lord during the feast,
每一次节期来到神面前之前,
the sins are transmitted to the lambs, the sheep, and the goat.
他们先把罪转到这些羊啊牛的身上,
and they are supposed to take the penalty of death on behalf of sinful man.
他们为所有的罪人承担罪的代价死亡。
Can you see this? While Israel were doing that in the west, the Chinese were doing this in the east, parallelly at the same time.
你看到了吗？以色列人在西方做这样的事时候，同时间中国人在东方做同样的仪式。Hebrews
9:22 says,
希伯来书9:22节说，
Without the shedding of blood, there is no forgiveness of sins.
若不流血，罪就不得赦免。The
Chinese always understood the importance of blood sacrifices.
华人一直都明白着流血献祭的重要。That's
why to the Chinese, whenever they cut a covenant, it must be cut in blood.
所以每一次华人要结盟的时候，一定要有流血的。So
we have the phrase 血盟 or blood covenant.
因此中文才有这个血盟之词。Even
when you want to join Chinese gangs,
即使你在中国参加帮派哦,
or you want to have a sworn brother relationship,
你要跟人结以为兄弟的时候,
the moment there's a covenant, it must be cut in blood.
要立这样的盟约，一定要有血的结合。Now
only the emperor himself could perform the border sacrifice ceremony.
当时只有皇帝有资格来主持整个的交际。And
they were called the Son of Heaven.
这些皇帝被称之为天子。So
the emperor functioned as high priest.
因此皇帝就好像大祭司一样。They
come before the altar and offer the sacrifice on behalf of the sin of the people.
来到坛前为所有百姓的罪献上这个祭物。So
they were both kings and priests unto their God.
因此在他们的神面前, 他们既是君王又是祭司。
Just like what the Bible would teach.
就像圣经要教我们的。
But they do get tired of those rituals.
可是这些礼仪是会让人厌烦的。
Every time doing it again and again.
他们每一次不断不断重复这样做。
Asking forgiveness for the same sin again and again without power of freedom.
为同样的罪不断不断求神的饶恕，却没有能力得到真正的自由。
Because how many of you know there is no permanent salvation for sin until the Messiah comes?
因为多少人知道，直到弥赛亚来到，不然罪没有办法得到永远的解决。
Because eternal salvation can only come when the ultimate King of Kings and the ultimate Great High Priest come to be the Lamb of God to take away the sin of the world.
因为只有当万王之王、真正的大祭司、神的羔羊除去所有世人的罪孽，才有永远的救恩。
Oh, you want to clap? Give the Lord a big clap.
为主热烈的拍掌。
Shout hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
So like the nation of Israel in the West,
就跟西方的以色列一样
the Chinese have a very elaborated blood sacrifice system.
华人有非常繁复整个流血献祭的仪式
And like the Israelites, the emperors practiced this for thousands of years without full understanding.
也跟以色列人一样皇帝这样做了几千年却完全不了解其中的含义
Once in a while, you have emperors that got tired of doing this.
可是每隔一段时间，会有一些皇帝厌倦不想这样做。
Now we find this especially during the reign of 秦始皇。
而在秦始皇掌政的时候，特别看到这一个。
Although he united China, he was the most corrupted king in Chinese history.
虽然他统一整个中国，然而在中国历史上，他是最残暴的一个君王。
And he rejected the worship of 上帝。
他也拒绝去拜这位上帝。
And do you know it's during his reign that massive idolatry came into China?
你知道就是在他的朝代使得中国进入了很多大举偶像的崇拜。
It was during his time when Taoism, Confucianism, and Buddhism grew and dominated the Chinese people.
而道教、佛教、儒家之所以能够主导整个中国也在他那个年代。
You see, when you refuse to worship the singular supreme God,Then all the idols will come in.
当你拒绝去拜这位独一真神的时候，其他所有的偶像就全部出现了。
Turn your Bible with me now to Matthew chapter 2.
跟我一起翻开马太福音第二章。
From the Old Testament, we come to the New Testament.
我们刚刚看了旧约，现在来到新约。
Here is something very interesting.
这是很有意思的地方。
Turn to your neighbor and say, "This is going to be so interesting."
跟旁边说，这非常有意思的。
Matthew 2 verses 1 and 2.
马太福音第二章一到二节。
Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem.
当希律王的时候，耶稣生在犹太的伯利恒，有几个博士从东方来到耶路撒冷。
Saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews?"
说那生下来做犹太人之王的在哪里
？We have seen his star in the east, have come to worship him.
我们在东方看见他的星，特来拜他。
Now, Bible scholars time this to be around 5 to 4 BC.
圣经学者将这样的时间放在大概公元前四到五年。
Now many people say this is just a fable.
很多人说，哎呀，这只是个神话。
How can you follow a star?
你怎么跟着星走啊
？Now what's interesting is this.
可是很有意思的是
，from ancient Chinese records，
在古代中国的记载里
，we know that the astronomers in China saw the same star.
我们知道中国的这些天文学家看到同样的一颗星哦。
You see, every night there were 14 imperial astronomers observing the night sky.
因为每个晚上最少有14名皇宫里面御用的占星家观察天象的。
When Jesus Christ was born, it was during the Han Dynasty.
当耶稣基督降生的时候，大概在中国的汉朝。
According to the astronomy records of the book of the Han Dynasty,
照着汉书《天文志》上面所记载的记录。
This was what they said.
这是他们所说的。二年二月，彗星出，牵牛七十余日，传日，牵牛日月，五星所从其，立数之源，三正之始，彗而出之，庚金之象也。其出九者，为其师大也。
Now listen to the English translation.
你听听它字面的解释是
：In the second month of the second year of Jianping, the comet was out of Altair for more than 70 days.
在建平第二年二月，有着彗星从牵牛星而出，超过七十多天。
It is said comets appear to signify the old being replaced by the new.
在这里，它是要显明新的要取代旧的。
Altair, the sun and the moon and the five stars are in movement to signify the beginning of a new epoch. The beginning of a new year, a new month, and a new day.
新的年份, 新的月份, 新的日子的开始,
the appearance of this comet undoubtedly symbolizes change.
这彗星的出现,
the extended appearance of this comet indicates that this is of great importance.
而这彗星出现的长短,
now, let's understand what this whole historical document is all about. 建平 was the name given to the Emperor of China during that time. So the sighting of a comet, you can pinpoint which period was that.
因此这个彗星的记载,
now the Chinese didn't know the truth of Jesus' birth in the West. But somehow they were convinced this event is of great importance.
然而他们确定的是这是非常非常重要的时间。
And it was in the second month of the second year, that means from March the 9th, to April the 6th, 5 BC.
这是在2年2月, 大概是公元前第五年, 3月9号到4月6号之间。
Pretty much coincide with what Bible scholars say about Jesus' birth.
哎, 这就非常符合学者们讲到耶稣诞生的日期。
And it says for 70 days, they saw this comet.
他们有70天都可以看到这个彗星。
70 days was the time needed for the wise men to travel from the Near East to Jerusalem.
这些博士要从近东地区来到耶路撒冷，就需要70天的路程。
People say, how could you follow a star?
人家说你怎么可能跟着星星啊？
It was a comet.
因为是彗星。
All right, so they did follow a star.
他们真的是跟着星星来的。
Now this comet was seen around Altair. In Chinese, is the word 牵牛。
这颗彗星是靠近牛郎星，也是所谓的牵牛星。
It is one of the 15 brightest stars in the night sky in China.
是在中国夜空当中看到第15亮的星星。
From the constellation of Aquila.
是靠近水瓶星群的。
Now, according to the classic historical records,
而照着史记上面所记载的, 他说正义牵牛为牺牲，以为官粮。
That means the primary meaning of Altair, the key supporting pillar of the heavens, is the perfect sacrifice.
他说牵牛是主要支撑天上的梁柱，它真正的意义要成为完美的牺牲。
So the Chinese believe heaven was trying to give a message.
华人相信上天要告诉我们一件事情。
Look at the comet.
你看着彗星。
Coming out a perfect sacrifice.
是要来成为完美的祭。
Amazing, it was prophetic. Although they didn't know what was happening.
非常神奇先知性的,
oh, come on, give the Lord a big hand.
Oh.
See, we serve a God who is alive. Oh, give him a big clap.
Hallelujah.
When you go to the gospel like Luke 23,
当你进到福音书, 好像路加福音23章,
it says when Jesus was hanging on the cross,
讲到耶稣被钉在十字架上的时候,
there was darkness in the land for at least 3 hours.
全地黑暗将近3个小时。
In China's records,
在中国的记载里面, 还有说, 鬼害会欲有时之, 必正殿请兵不听是五日, 诏曰无德保止灾, 折间逾越, 站立恐惧, 符合言哉, 其上书者不得言胜。
Now it means in the day of Guihai, the last day of the month, there was a solar eclipse.
他讲到在那月最后日鬼害日有日食发生。
The emperor avoided the throne room, suspended all military activities, and did not handle official business for 5 days.
皇帝躲在寝宫里面,不敢出兵,有5天不敢问朝事。
He proclaimed, my poor character has caused this calamity.
他宣布是因为我福德不足造成这个灾害。
That the sun and the moon were veiled.
使得日月无光。
I'm fearful and trembling. What can I say?
我恐惧战惊能怎么说呢?
Anyone who presents a memorial is not allowed to mention the word holy.
任何提及的人不可提及圣字。
Now, Guihai was the last day of the third month in the spring during the 7th year of the Han Emperor Guanwu.
而鬼害这日是在光武帝第七年春天第三个月的最后一天。
You can pinpoint that to AD 31.
这个日期你去抓呢, 大概就在公元31年了。
Exactly 34 years after the comet was sighted that moved for 70 days. That was the life of Jesus. So when he was born, there was a sign in heaven, the Chinese saw it.
当耶稣出生，天上有天象，中国人看见了。
When he died, there was a sign in heaven, and the Chinese saw it and recorded it.
当他死亡的时候，天上有天象，华人看见也记载下来了。
Even give us the exact time and day.
甚至给我们非常精确的日期。
Another document, a more amazing entry was made in the same documents.
同一份记载里面另外一个部分看见更神奇的一个事情。他说：“夏四月闰午，昼曰，比阴阳错谬，日月薄时，百姓有过在于一人，大赦天下。”Now
listen to what it says.
他怎么说的呢？
Summer fourth month of the year on the day of 闰午, the imperial edict reads.
在夏天，在第七月的壬午这一日，皇帝下诏.
Yin and Yang have mistakenly switched, and the sun and moon were eclipsed.
阴与阳交错，太阳、日月两无光。
The sins of all the people are now on one man, and pardon is proclaimed to all under heaven.
Wow. 所有人的过犯现在在一人身上，使得天下众人得以赦免。
Oh, hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Look, when the emperor Guan Wu saw this, he got convicted of his sin. He got fearful.
当光武帝看见这一切，很明白自己的罪孽，开始恐惧了。
He said, "It is my sin. It is our sin that is causing this calamity."
他说是我的罪，我们的罪造成这样的灾害。
And he proclaimed the sins of all the people were laid on one man.
他宣告所有人的罪放在一人的身上。
Did he really understand what he was saying?
他真的明白他在说什么吗？
We can't be sure, but he was prophetic, and he was accurate to say that the sin was on one man, and we know. He's Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. 我们不确定他明白什么，但是这样的精确先知性话语，明白所有罪孽在一个人身上，就是在耶稣基督身上。
Oh, come on, give the Lord a big hand.
为主热烈的拍掌。
Even more incredibly, there was a commentary in the records of the latter Han Dynasty.
而更神奇的是，在后汉书里面有这样的一段记载。 他说：“癸亥日时，天人崩。”
Eclipse on the day of 癸亥, man from heaven died.
癸亥那日的日时，天上来的人死亡了。
They could even say on the exact day, the Son of God died. Wow.
讲到那当天，神的儿子死亡。
And then 3 days later, the Chinese astronomers recorded this.
3天之后，中国的天象学家又记载了。 光武建武七年四月丙寅，日有晕报，白虹贯晕。
That means during the reign of Emperor Guan Wu, on the day of 丙寅, on the fourth month of 建武, a halo, a rainbow, encircled the sun.
他讲到光武皇帝建武七年四月丙寅那天，当时太阳旁边有一圈红彩围绕。
So they noticed 3 days after the solar eclipse, another sign in heaven.
在那日食之后三天，再一次天上有天象出现。
What happened 3 days after Jesus' death?
耶稣死后第三天怎么样了？
He resurrected, he rose from the dead. He's alive, hallelujah.
他从死里复活，继续永远的活着， hallelujah.
Oh, come on, let's give the Lord a big hand.
为主热烈的拍掌。
Isn't that amazing?
这是不是很神奇的？
His birth, his death, his resurrection, all recorded in Chinese historical documents.
他的出生、他的死亡、他的复活，都在华人的历史记载里面记录了。Well,
so did Christianity come to China?
所以基督信仰真的来到中国了吗？
Well, 500 years ago,
大概500年前,
there was a missionary called Matteo Ricci, an Italian.
一位意大利的宣教士叫利马窦。
He was a lawyer and a first-class scientist who became a Jesuit priest.
他原来是律师跟第一流的科学家，后来做了耶稣会的修士。In
the Roman Catholic Church, the most fervent, the most disciplined, the most on fire group of people are the Jesuits.
在所有天主教徒当中，那些最火热、虔诚、为神摆上的，就是耶稣会的。In
1583, Ricci and his friend became missionaries to China.
1583年，利玛窦跟他的朋友到中国来宣教。
Settling in Guangdong province, they studied Chinese, wore Chinese clothes, and make Chinese friends.
他们安顿在广东省那里，开始学习华文，穿中国人的衣服，交中国人的朋友。
Matteo Ricci was a brilliant man. He studied and mastered the Chinese classics, including the writings on Confucius and Mencius.
他学习之后,精通所有中国的经书,包括孔孟的学说在内。
In a very short time, he became equal to the best scholars in China.
在很短时间之内,他的学问跟中国的学者毫不逊色。
Now, Ricky taught Western science to the Chinese scholars.
而立马都把西方的科学交给中国的学者。
He was the first man who introduced China to the world map.
他是第一个把世界地图带进中国的人。
And for the first time, the Chinese people know where they were in the scheme of the world.
头一次中国人知道自己在世界上是站在哪个角落。
He taught them Western mathematics and astronomy.
同时他也教他们西方的数学跟科学。
As Ricky studied the classics, he realized the Chinese characters, the worship system, the blood sacrifice, that the 上帝 of the Chinese is the same God of the Bible.
他从所有中国的文字、所有献祭的仪式、跟他所有的礼仪当中明白，中国的上帝跟圣经的神完全一样。
So what I shared with you last week and this week, basically, Matteo Ricci was the first man who discovered it.
我上个星期跟这个星期所分享的东西，基本上立马都是第一个发现的人。
Let me tell you what he wrote in Chinese, and mind you, this Italian man wrote in 文言文。
我让你看看他在中文怎么写，是个意大利人哦，写的是文言文哦。
So if you can't write Chinese. I don't know what to say.
如果你中文都写不出来，都不知道该怎么说了。
If an Italian man can write 文言文, ancient Chinese,
意大利人能够写文言文出来嘞。
All right, let's say what. Let's read what he says.
看看利玛窦怎么说的。他说：“历观古书，而知上帝与天主特意以明。”That
means having lived through a great number of ancient books, it is quite clear to me that the Sovereign on High and the Lord of Heaven are different only in name.
他说，当我看到所有中国的古书之后，很清楚地明白，他们所谓的上帝跟我们的天主只有姓名的差别而已。Now,
he wrote a few pages away.
而之后呢，他又讲到无天主即华严上帝。He
who is called the Lord of Heaven in my humble country is he who is called 上帝 in Chinese.
在我们国家所谓的天主就是华人所谓的上帝。So
the missionary Ricky got very excited.
这位宣教士立马都很兴奋了。He
began to show the Chinese the similarities.
他可以让华人看见这样的雷同性。And
he translated many Christian books into Chinese.
也把很多基督教书籍翻译成华文。And
translated the Chinese books into Latin for the Europeans.
也把华文翻成拉丁文，让欧洲人能读。So
he was the first man that showed Europe the Chinese culture.
他是第一个让欧洲人看见华人文化的。Now
Ricky showed a great respect to the Chinese and their culture.
立马都非常尊重华人跟他们的文化。Now
listen to this.
仔细听好哦。To
win them over, he sometimes dressed himself as a Buddhist monk or as a Confucian scholar.
为了赢得这些人，有时候立马都会穿上那些和尚的袍子，或是儒家学者的衣服。Now
the Jesuits are the most spiritual Catholics.
耶稣会是最属灵的天主教徒哎。But
yet Ricky was not religious at all.
但他完全不宗教化哦。His
strategy was to engage the culture of the Chinese and win them to Christ through his genuine love and friendship.
他的策略是希望进入华人的文化当中，以自己真诚的友谊跟爱来为基督赢得这些人。Now
stop for a moment and think about this.
先停停想想看啊。He
identified with them by even willing to dress as a Buddhist monk.
他认同这些人到一个地步，愿意穿得跟和尚一样。Think
about this.
想想看哦。What
happens if one Sunday morning you come to church?
如果有一个礼拜天早上你到教会来。
Pastor Kong came dressed as a Buddhist monk and carry a Bible and preach.
康牧师穿着和尚的袈裟到台上拿着圣经讲道。
Think about, just imagine.
你想象一下好不好?
Here I am, not in my suit and tie.
我站在这儿，不是穿西装打领带的。
Wearing an orange saffron robe.
而穿的是那个黄色的袈裟。
Having beads around me.
哇，身上还大挂着佛珠。
But carry a Bible and preach like a man on fire.
可是拿着圣经像火热的一样教导。
How many of you will still stay in City Harvest Church?
还有多少人会继续留在城市丰收啊?
Or will you immediately take photograph on your handphone, put it on internet, and say, look, the pastor has gone crazy?
还是你马上拿手机出来帮他拍一张,放到网络上面说, 你看我们牧师发疯了。
Will you immediately write to the forum and say, we need a press conference. This man has gone bonkers.
还是你会马上去写信到报社, 说我们需要开记者会, 因为这个人已经完全出轨了。
He has renounced his faith.
他弃绝他的信仰了。
He got demonized.
哇,他被魔鬼附了。
How can he come to church or dress as a Buddhist monk?
他怎么可以穿着和尚的袈裟到教会来?
But you see, Matteo Ricci, to him, holiness is not what you wear.
可是对利马窦来说, 圣洁不在乎你穿什么。
Doesn't matter if you dress like a Buddhist monk.
你穿得像不像和尚没有关系。
Or you have a picture of Buddhist monk on your jeans.
还是你牛仔裤上面有一个和尚的图案。
Makes no difference.
没差嘛。
Yeah? Holiness is a matter of the heart.
圣洁是在乎你的内心。
I can't hear you. Want to clap? Give the Lord a big clap.
最热烈掌声归给主。
His goal is to gain a position in the royal palace and share the love of Christ to the Chinese emperor himself.
他的目标是也能够争取到一席之地进到皇宫，有一天亲自跟皇帝分享基督的爱。
Because you can't change a nation without changing the elite at the top.
因为你不能改变上流社会的精英分子，就不能改变社会。
Change can only come top down.
改变是从上到下。
They believe if they can change and convert the king of China, they will change the whole nation of China.
他相信当皇帝悔改得救，整个中国就要得救了。
That is why I don't believe in isolation.
所以我不相信隔绝了。
I believe you got to engage the marketplace.
我相信你要进入职场。
You got to get into third space and become an ambassador of Christ to the power that be. Hallelujah.
成为基督的大使，进入到第三层的世界里面，带着他的荣耀。
Come on, give the Lord a big clap.
为主热烈的拍掌。
After 20 years of hard work,
在他努力20年之后,
20 years of faith,
信心的20年,
Ricky became an advisor to the Emperor Wang Li, and he was the first foreigner to become an advisor.
利马窦成为万历皇帝的顾问, 也是历史上面第一个西洋人的皇帝顾问。
Here was a pastor,
这是一位牧师,
a Jesuit priest, a missionary,
一个宣教士耶稣会的修士,
became a mathematician, a scientist to the Chinese,
对华人来说,
and a political advisor to the king. Just like Daniel in the Bible. Just like Joseph in the Bible. And today, we have people in the church who are so religious. If the pastor enters the marketplace, they go crazy. Listen, if you think engaging the marketplace is wow, so modern and so contemporary,
如果你觉得进入职场是这么现代化的想法,
500 years people have already done it. You're super behind time.
500年前大家就做, 你真的落伍久了。
You're not just coming out of the 20th century.
你现在不是从20世纪出来,
you are living in the 16th century.
你是活在16世纪的。
Time for you to get alive and get updated with the will of God. Hallelujah.
该好好清醒, 让神的话语来更新你了。
Oh, you want to clap? Give the Lord a big clap.
给热烈的拍掌。
Woo! Well, Matteo Ricci lived only 58 years.
利马窦只活了58岁.
He died quite a young man.
蛮年轻就过世了.
But in that time, Ricci led 2,500 Chinese to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
可他为耶稣基督赢得2,500名华人.
First man to bring the gospel to China.
第一个将把福音带进中国的人.
Oh, give the Lord a big clap.
为主热烈的拍掌.
He established 4 mission bases all throughout China. And through the love and friendship of his workers, the fellow Jesuit priests, one by one among the Chinese elite, the top of society, the cream of society, they came to Christ.
当时华人社会最高级上流社会的人，这些皇宫贵族一个一个相信耶稣。
By 1664, there were more than 250,000 Christians in China now.
到1664年, 中国已经超过25万的基督徒了。
Many princes, empresses, dowagers became Christians and were water baptized.
很多都是皇家的王公贵族成了基督徒受了洗。
Among those that got saved was the one of the greatest, if not the greatest emperor in Chinese history.
而在得救的人当中, 有一位是中国历史上最重要的一位君王之一。
He was a Qing emperor by the name of Kangxi Wangdi.
就是清朝的康熙皇帝。
And he began ruling at the age of 14.
他14岁开始执掌皇权。
Kangxi was tutored by another Jesuit missionary, a Christian, who was a brilliant scientist and mathematician.
而由另外一位耶稣会的宣教士，非常聪明的科学家南怀仁曾经教导过康熙。
His name was Ferdinand Verbiest.
他的名字叫南怀仁。
A missionary.
是位宣教士。
But a mathematician, a brilliant scientist.
是一个数学的科学家，非常非常聪明的人。
See a few things you need to learn over here.
在这里你需要学几个东西啊。
The Bible says a man's gift and talent makes room for himself.
圣经告诉我们，人的恩赐才华能为他打开路。
If you don't use your gift and talent, you're not going to go far in life.
如果不使用你的恩赐才华，你在生命中走不远的。
The Bible says the man of excellence will stand before kings.
圣经说，卓越之人能站立在君王面前。
So if you live an average, mediocre life, you are never going to influence the power that be.
如果你只活在平庸的生活当中，你不可能影响真正有权力的人。
You got to excel in life.
你要在生命中卓越。
And all these Jesuit missionaries excel in life.
这些耶稣会修士在生命中非常卓越的。
They were educated, they were sophisticated.
是受过高深教育，非常精致的。
Non-religious and very progressive.
不宗教化，非常进步的。
That's what I want you to become.
这是我希望你的情况。
Every member of City Harvest Church.
城市丰盛教会每一个会友。
Educated and sophisticated.
受过教育，精致化。
Colorful, vivacious.
多才多姿，大胆的。
Successful, sophisticated.
成功的，非常高深的。
For too long, for too long.
已经太久太久以来。
Many people cannot accept the church and success in the same sentence.
很多人不能够接受同一个句子里面既有教会又有成功。
Many people cannot accept the church and progress in the same sentence.
很多人不能够接受教会跟进步放在一起。
So the church is backward.
教会就很落伍了。
The church is always behind time.
教会一直在时间之后。
The church are always low-class people.
都是那些最低层的人。
Well, God raised up City Harvest Church to change that in our generation.
神兴起城市丰盛，在我们这个时代改变这一点。
God has raised up to change that in the whole world for the body of Christ.
兴起我们在全世界为基督的身体改变这一点。
Come on, give the Lord a big clap.
为主热烈的拍掌。
Woo! Man, I'm preaching today.
哇，真的在讲道嘞。
Kangxi was converted to Christ.
康熙相信了基督。
And he wrote 30,000 poems.
他写了3万多首诗。
One of the most educated emperors ever in history.
在人类历史上面，非常有高深教育的一个皇帝。
He knew science, he knew mathematics, he was well versed in culture.
他了解科学、数学，非常熟悉文化。
Kangxi's reign was known as the golden era of China.
康熙的掌权在中国认为是清朝的黄金年代。
And he wrote wonderful poems to glorify God.
而他写了很美的诗来荣耀上帝。
I'm going to show you a picture of his actual handwriting, his calligraphy.
我让你看看他自己书法的真迹。
How do you know this is written by him?
你怎么知道是康熙写的？
His royal seal is imprinted over there.
他在那里亲自下了署名在那儿。
Now, we are not even going to try to read the whole thing.
因为整个东西太长了，不会把它念完的。
But I want to read to you the last few lines.
你看看最后的两行怎么说的？天门久未出人闭。
That means heaven's gate was closed due to the first man's sin, the sin of Adam.
福禄全得圣子通。
The path to salvation is only through the Son.
我愿接受神圣子。
I'm willing to accept the Holy Son of God.
儿子名分得永生。
And through him, I receive eternal life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, give the Lord a big hand.
为主热烈的拍掌。
Amen.
Amen.
So many people say, oh, Chinese don't accept Christianity.
很多人说，哎呀，华人不相信基督教的。
Oh, Christianity, Western religion.
基督信仰西方人的宗教。
Not true, not true, not true.
不对哦，不对哦，不对哦。
First of all, long time ago, before idols came in, they already worshipped the same God of the Bible.
实际上，早在偶像进来很久以前，他们就敬拜同一位跟圣经一样的真神。
And the greatest emperor in history of the Chinese people is a Christian himself.
而中国历史上最伟大的一位君王自己也是基督徒。
He wrote another poem.
他写了另外一首诗，这里他前面两句是这样说的：“功成十架写成稀。”
His work was completed on the cross. And his blood shed like a creek.
百丈恩流分自西。
Such deep stream of grace flowed from the west. All right? Now, where was China relative to Israel?
你要了解，对中国来说，以色列在哪里？
China is in the east, Israel is in the west.
中国在东方，以色列在西方。
He says, the work of the cross is completed, and the grace of God is flowing to us Chinese people from the West.
他说十字架的工作成就，而神的恩典自西方流到中国来。
So excited was Emperor Kangxi of Christianity.
哇，康熙对基督信仰是这样的兴奋。
By 1692, he issued an edict granting Christians all throughout China to evangelize.
在1692年，康熙下了诏谕，让所有中国的基督教可以自由传播。
That means it's not like, well, you know, if you want to, you can do it.
不是说，哎呀，你想你就自己去传吧。
He sent a royal edict.
他亲自下皇诏。
Let's Christianize China.
让整个中国变基督化。
Every Christian should preach and teach and convert people to Christ.
每一个基督徒都应该传讲教导使人相信耶稣。
Revival was spreading all throughout China.
复兴在中国各地开始发生。
And then crisis hit.
可是危机临到。
Now there were persecution.
有逼迫发生了。
But that is not the greatest enemy.
可是那不是最大的敌人。
There were anti-Christians.
有敌基督的事情。
But they were not the enemies.
可他们也不是仇敌。
Where did the problem come from?
问题来自哪里？
Some leaders within the Catholic Church were against the missionaries engaging Chinese culture.
天主教教会里面有一些领袖反对这些宣教士接触中国文化。
The enemy of the work of the cross were the religious Christians.
十架工作的敌人是那些宗教化的基督徒。
Why? They considered Chinese pagans. They looked down on them.
为什么？他们觉得中国人是异教徒，根本轻看这些人。
Look down on their culture. Look down on their language.
轻视他们的文化，轻视他们的语言。
You shouldn't be learning to speak the Chinese language.
你不应该学着说中文的。
It's demonic, you know.
嘿，邪恶的哦。
And they condemn all Chinese emperors to burn in hell.
他们定罪所有的中国皇帝是要在地狱里焚烧的。
And they demanded all converts to give up the rights of honoring their ancestors.
同时要求所有中国的信徒放弃所有纪念祖先的仪式。
Now you got to understand Chinese culture.
你要了解中国的文化。
For 4,500 years,
4,500年来
China or Chinese people worship 上帝 but they always honor their elders. It's in the culture.
中国人虽然敬拜上帝，但他们懂得慎终追远，纪念祖先是文化里面的。
Most people don't have ancestral worship.
大部分的人不是去拜他们的祖先
but they honor the dead.
而是尊荣纪念死者。
康熙 make it very clear.
康熙讲得很清楚。
He and most Chinese believe in a supreme sovereign most high God.
他跟大部分中国人都相信同一位独一的真神。
The rites of honoring ancestors were only signs of respect.
这些纪念祖先的仪式不过是表示尊敬而已。
They don't pray to them.
他不向他们祷告。
They are not afraid of departed spirits.
也不害怕那些死人的灵魂。
And they have no superstitious beliefs concerning spirits.
在这些邪灵的事上面，他们不是这么迷信的人。
But the Pope cannot accept it.
可是教皇当时不接受。
Now this became known in history as a rite controversy.
在历史上，这被称为中国礼仪之争。
Pope Clement the 11th sent zealous missionaries to Kangxi.
而当时的教皇克雷芒十一世就差了非常狂热的宣教士到康熙面前
demanding all China must renounce the honoring of their ancestors
要求全中国要放弃纪念祖先的事
Now the missionaries he sent were overzealous
猜过去的宣教士过度狂热
hyper religious
超级狂热的人
totally insensitive to the feelings of the Chinese
宗教化完全不感受中国人的感觉
they ended up insulting the Chinese, their culture, and even their fellow Jesuit missionaries
到最后是侮辱中国人他们的文化甚至他们那些耶稣会的修士
one of them was a French bishop who went to the emperor, insulted him, and challenged him
而其中一个是法国的一个主教去侮辱康熙同时挑衅他
Oh, Kangxi 皇帝 was so stumbled.
康熙皇帝受到非常大的屈辱
With that, he banned Christianity in China.
因此他禁止基督教再进入中国
And listen to what he said.
听听他怎么说的
I have concluded that the Westerners are petty indeed.
我这样看见外国人真的是太小心眼了
It is impossible to reason with them because they do not understand larger issues as we understand them in China.
没有办法跟他们解释中国人所明白的大是大非。
There is not a single Westerner verse in Chinese works, and their remarks are often incredible and ridiculous.
西洋人根本不了解中国的文字，也没有办法说明他们所讲的实在是太荒谬了。
To judge from this proclamation,
从他们带来的条约看来
，So this was the demand of the Pope.
这是教皇带过来的条约。
All right, their religion is no different from other small bigoted sects of Buddhism or Taoism.
他们竟和和尚道士这些异端小教一样。
I have never seen a document which contains so much nonsense.
没看过什么文件上有这么多胡言乱语的。
From now on, Westerners should not be allowed to preach in China to avoid further trouble.
以后西洋人不可再在中国传教，免得多生事端。
With that, evangelism stopped.
到这里，整个宣教就结束了。
How silly is that?
多愚蠢啊！
God opened up the whole nation.
神打开整个国家耶！
And some religious people came in and insulted, and because they were intolerant.
就因为这些宗教化的人是不能够接纳，开始侮辱这些人。
Kangxi, because he was so influenced by the missionaries, and he loved the missionaries, the Jesuit missionaries.
康熙非常爱这些耶稣会的宣教士，也跟他们有很好的感情。
Secretly, he tried to negotiate a solution with the Pope.
私底下还是希望跟教皇能达成协议。
I don't believe in ancestral worship, he said.
他说我们不是在做祖先的敬拜。
We don't pray to idols.
我们不对偶像祷告。
We don't pray to the dead.
也不向死人祷告。
But we do want to honor our ancestors.
可是我们要纪念尊敬我们的祖先。
He was trying to convince the Pope that all these rites were civil and not religious.
他要劝服教皇，这些是我们的文化，而不是宗教。
The Pope refused to relent.
然而教皇确实不肯放手。
Emperor Kangxi was so saddened, and this was what he commanded.
康熙皇帝非常的难过，这是他后来说的评语。
He wrote a letter to the Pope.
他写了一封信给教皇。
You have corrupted your teachings and disrupted the efforts of the former Westerners.
你是自毁你的教导，妨碍之前洋人的努力。This
is definitely not the will of your God.
这绝不是你上帝的旨意。For
he leads men to good deeds.
因为他是要引众人向善。I've
often heard from you, Westerners, that the devil leads men astray. This must be it.
我常听你们洋人说，魔鬼才引人误入歧途，应该就是这样了。Isn't
what he says so true?
他讲的是不是真的？
Isn't what he says so true about religious people?
他对那些宗教化人士所讲的是不是真的？
They are the greatest enemy of the cross.
他们施加最大的敌人。
By their narrow-mindedness.
因为他们思想狭隘。
Intolerance.
不肯接纳。
Unwilling to accept people who are different from them.
不愿意接受那些跟他们不一样的人。
For them, they only have one narrow way, my way or no way, and their way is not even biblical.
而他们只有一条狭隘的道路，照我的方式，不然免谈。 而他们道路还不合圣经嘞。
With that, the work of God was hampered for the next few hundred years.
因为这样，接下来几百年神的工作受到拦阻。
How sad it is!
多么难过啊！
God giving China a Kairos moment.
神给了中国这样属神的时刻。
And it's the people within the church that came against it because they believe in isolation.
而就因为教会的人相信孤绝，所以才能够拦阻这一切。
You have learned the working of God among the Chinese these 2 weeks.
这两个星期，你学到神在中国历史当中的工作。
You have seen how God is working behind the scene among the Chinese people from its very beginning 4,500 years ago.
你看见神在一开头4,500年前就在幕后整个中国历史当中来运作。
Don't let anyone tell you that it's not right for Chinese to become Christians.
别让别人告诉你说华人是不可以做基督徒的。
Let me tell you the converse is true.
我告诉你，反过来才是对的。
It's only natural for Chinese to become Christians.
华人最自然的是应该成为基督徒。
Because this is the first and only faith we always have known from the very beginning.
因为最起初就是我们为是唯一的信仰。
Come on, give the Lord a big clap.
为主热烈的拍掌。
Oh, give the Lord a big hand.
热烈掌声归主。
Don't let anyone tell you your parents cannot be saved.
别让任何人告诉你的父母不能得救。
Don't let anybody tell you your grandparents cannot be saved.
别让任何人告诉你的祖父母不能得救。
Don't let anybody tell you the Chinese people should not become Christians.
别让任何人告诉你中国人是不应该信基督教的。
That is a lie from the pit of hell.
那是从地狱来的谎言。
You have seen how by engaging culture you can change a whole nation.
你看到了，当你进入文化，可以改变整个国家的。
Yet you have also seen the greatest enemy of the cross is not Satan the devil.
但同时你也看到，施加最大的敌人不是魔鬼撒旦。
Very often I hear this everywhere I go.
不论我去到哪里，我常常听到这个。
Oh, you know, oh, we got to come against the territorial spirits.
哦，我们要抵挡这个区域的邪灵。
Oh, there's territorial spirits that's stopping revival.
哦，是区域的邪灵拦阻整个复兴啊。
I like what one pastor say.
我很喜欢一个牧师说的。
The territorial spirits are not demons.
区域的邪灵不在魔鬼身上。Territorial
spirits very often are the religious Christians.
常常是那些宗教化的基督徒才有。The
religious pastors.
那宗教化的牧师。
You know, you got to get out of that mindset.
你必须要放掉这样的心态了。
All right? Instead of cultural isolation, We preach separation and we practice isolation.
我们讲分别,
That's wrong.
这是错的。
The Bible teaches us insulation.
圣经教导我们的,
we get insulated by the blood.
要用宝血使我们绝缘,
by the word, by prayer, by the Holy Spirit.
借着话语, 借着祷告, 借着圣灵,
we get insulation for penetration in society. Oh, give the Lord a big hand.
为主热烈的拍掌。
Help me preach this morning, right? Give the Lord praise. Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Bible teaches it is relationship that precedes ministry. You can win an argument, but lose a relationship. All right, you're theologically very smart. All right, you know all the names of God. The Greek and the Hebrew. The five I wills of the devil. The seven proclamations in Revelation 2 and 3.
启示录第二、第三章里面七项宣告。
You can win a theological debate, but lose a relationship. And without relationship, there's no way you can influence anybody to Christ. You can't win someone over without first stepping into his world and enter into his culture. But anyhow, we see a good God loving the Chinese people. From its very beginning and all throughout history. Leading them very much the same way he led the Israelites in the Bible. Bring them to the place where they are open to receive Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior of their soul. So let's be confident. We in Asia, this is the last bastion of revival. We are going to see the greatest revival in our generation. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now listen, listen, listen.
听好,
I'm so happy I live in Asia. Although I preach all around the world, I come back here almost every week. Because I don't want to be anywhere else where the Spirit of God is working. God gave us the most number of people in Asia. And God put us in a place where people are ready to receive Jesus. So let's do everything we can. Engage culture. Don't become limited in our thinking. Don't become so religious. But be open-hearted. Let's engage our world and lead the greatest revival of our generation in the history of the world. Musicians, come out right now. Give the Lord a big clap.
Hallelujah.
How many of you, you want to believe God that your family can get saved? Put up your hands right now. How many of you have parents and grandparents that are yet to get saved? Put up your hands. I want to tell you, they can get saved. They can get saved. Because God is the God of Chinese people. Deep in our Chinese psyche, there's already an openness and a hunger for Shangdi. Not for idols, but for the one real God, one true God. So let's believe God this year will be the year of breakthrough, the year of salvation. That this year our parents, our grandparents will get saved. Alright, and the only way we're going to see that happen, first, you got to begin in your thinking. You got to visualize them getting saved. Believe they will get saved. And begin to speak out and pray that they will get saved. So let's quickly stand on our feet right now. Lift our holy hands and talk before the Lord right now. Let's pray for the salvation of family members.